in the room. Come on in the room. Yes. So we're excited that you made it in here. So when he launches that, if you're my friend on Facebook, just go on and share with the world. Share, share, share. We have some great stuff that's going to take place, but we need to start with prayer. And one of my team members, Danielle, is going to go ahead and open us in prayer.
Yes, Father, we just thank you today. We thank you for the vision that you are first the visionary. God, we thank you for everybody that has come and joined globally, international, for you are the God of the universe. God, we thank you because without you, we would perish with no vision. And today you have given each and every one, every woman, every household a vision for their lives and their household. God, let today be the changing point of their lives. Let them launch over to 2021. Lord, they had expectations for 2020, but God, let 2021 outdo every other year that they had before. God, I thank you that each and every speaker, as they come forth with power, unction, and demonstration, that lives will be changed, prayers will be answered, and questions will be answered as well. Father, we thank you for Denise Armstrong, who shall go forth as our host today, leading and guiding the way. We thank you for the visionary Chris Scott, and we thank you for the powerful woman that shall come forth, giving us the rhema word that God has. Your presence be felt, and let us have a good time in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much for that, Danielle. Look at all these beautiful faces. Ladies, I want you to go ahead and put in chat where you're streaming from, whatever state, whatever country. Just go ahead and put it in chat so we can have some fun. Does anybody have their supplies? Are we ready? We're about to run into 2021, y'all. Vision ready. We're going to write that vision today, and all the things that you're believing God for is going to be totally, totally amazing. We have some powerful women coming forth to give a word, to give a testimony. And then later on, we have our very own Dr. Patricia Bailey that's going to join us and give us a word for 2021. So we're excited. We're on a global platform, ladies. We are streaming live in South Africa, Nigeria. And Ashton, you got to tell me where else we are. Just put it in chat and I'll share with the ladies. So we have Hampton, Georgia in the house. The ladies are putting it all in there and I am so excited. And you know what? I can talk. So I'm not going to do that right now. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and get ready to introduce our amazing host, really good friend of mine. And you know, this is her second year hosting. So I am just so excited that she said yes. I feel like I got engaged. You know, she said yes, y'all. So I'm excited to have my sister and my good friend here with us. So, you know, Denise Armstrong, named one of the powerful Black women in the beauty industry by Salon Sense magazine to encourage you, worth watching, rave reviews, TV 57 Atlanta Live, co-host with her late husband, and I feel like I knew him, Lee, you know, just an amazing man of God. You can find her serving Dr. Daisy Jones as a reoccurring co-host of Comcast Channel 28. She just expresses herself in such an amazing way with her show, Can We Talk, that comes on live on Facebook every Sunday morning. And I love to watch it. It inspires me. Such an amazing woman of God. I affectionately call her Pastor Denise. And Denise is also the CEO of Image Makers, Inc. as a marketplace minister. She is determined to take the industry back for him, the industry, that's the industry of the arts, film, theater, all of that. And I love what she's doing for my my theatrical brothers and sisters, those in film and those on stage. Honored to feed you spiritual and physically. She also delivers food to the elderly throughout the community. She has served on the advisory board of Rainbow House in Atlanta for abused children. And she's just truly amazing, y'all. And Denise has a blended family, amazing grandchildren. Her personal triumphs of turbulent times are shared in a balanced message, leaving her audience encouraged and laughing. She has done numerous commercials. You've probably seen her in the film that came out last year called Overcomer. She played the grandmother. She is an amazing actress, and I'm going to show you right now before she comes forth how amazing she is. And go ahead and run that video for me, Christine, our amazing Christine.
Video of
Denise Armstrong.
Okay.
And that's okay. If you don't have it, we'll come back to it. But it's Denise is real, and we were just going to play just the first part, that first clip.
Maybe come back to Denise?
We'll come back
to it. Because she's so fabulous.
So we're going to have Denise go ahead now. And Denise, take it away, my sister, my beautiful golden locks sister.
Hey, well, hello, 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 beautiful women and men, because we know that there are some men that are listening. I am so excited for you to come and participate in something. Many of you have been here longer than I. This is my second time. I'm honored to be here. But are you ready? Do you have your vision boards ready? Do you have your goals and objectives ready? Are you ready to fall into the avenue of the things that you want, the desires of your heart? Because if you are, we're ready for you. And do we have the support that's available to you? We have amazing sponsors that have sponsored us this year and last year that are here to meet your every need. Get ready. As you do your vision board, make sure that you have your notebook to take your nuggets and get everything in line for the things that you're going to learn, because today is just for you. Today is the answered prayer for you. And if you're a person that, you know, you don't pray out loud, it doesn't matter. He's heard you. And I guarantee you that after these hours we spend together, you're going to walk away feeling brand new. So I am just welcoming you here, everyone. And as we begin, I want to also introduce you to our number one speaker. And I am just so excited about her. Her name is Vanessa Johnson. And you know what we call her? We call her the lighthouse in the storm. Vanessa Fireball Johnson hails from New York City. I'm a New Yorker, hey, hey, sister, and the CEO of Dunamis Dominion LLC. She is an ordained pastor, prophetess, and strategist who uses her practical principles for the word to help other people confront and overcome, little pun for the movie, overcome their obstacles they are facing and to bring them to a path of a new beginning. Isn't that what we want for 2021, a new beginning? She believes in taking these principles to the street and opening demonstration of God's power and righteousness. Are you ready for the lighthouse in a storm, Vanessa Johnson? While we're waiting for Vanessa, guys, the first film that you saw was one of our sponsors, and that is from Hilton Johns Jones Media, and they meet every media need. And so we're gonna come back to that. But right now, Vanessa Johnson. I think we're on mute and we're missing the wonderful, come on, Vanessa. Oh,
my walk with God and what he endows from me and through me to you. So here's my story. I, at between 7 and 8 years of age, was molested as a child. Going into my teenage years, I experienced domestic violence for 7 years. And throughout the 7 years, I was pregnant. And in that, I picked the story up to you where I had been going through so much abuse in my teenage years, and me being pregnant, I decided that I no longer wanted to live. And so in deciding that, I came home from school one day and sat under my five-story window, contemplating jumping, taking the life of me and my child. As I was contemplating jumping and about to write my note to my mom to let her know, you know, the reasons why I was doing what I was about to do, I heard the Spirit of the Living God say unto me, Vanessa, you have someone on the inside of you to live for. Live this day. And I was in awe because I had audibly heard God's voice speak to me, and it changed my life forever. My son is now 33 years old. I thank God for him being the one that God used to keep me here, so I did not commit that suicide. But throughout the years thereafter, being married, how I found out about me being molested was the fact that when I got married, we started having intimacy issues, and I couldn't understand why. And so me being who I am, I took a trip down memory lane with the Holy Spirit, and he began to let me know that I had suppressed all those years of what had happened to me. And so as he took me through those years, he began to start it an inner healing on the inside of me. And as he did that, I began to get healed from the molestation that had taken place, the traumatic experience that I had experienced from that. I began to get healed from the domestic violence that had taken place in my life. And throughout that years, you know, I'm fast forwarding because I know that, you know, this message has to be short and quick, but I'm fast forwarding to the point where I'm at in my life, and I am now I'm evolving, I'm teaching others, I'm coaching others, I'm mentoring others. But at the same time, I was still experiencing depression and other suicidal thoughts because now I'm into a marriage, a second marriage that I should not be in, because God told me twice not to get in. But because Vanessa wanted companionship, Vanessa got in this marriage. And so I experienced, you know, a deeper depression. More suicidal thoughts came to me. But I tell you what, we serve an amazing God, because throughout this, God gave me the brand name, The Fight Is Fixed. And that's what I held on to as I asked the Holy Spirit to take me back through those processes again so that I can face it, to fix it. And that's what he did. And I became completely whole from depression. I became completely whole from suicidal thoughts. I became completely whole from every traumatic experience that I had experienced in my life, because God began to show me, Vanessa, you're living. The fight is fixed. All of this was fixed for such a time as this. And so I am so thankful for what God has done in my life, because going through those things and understanding that some of you may have possibly went through the same things, you have to allow the Holy Spirit to take you back to face it, to fix it, and deal with it so that those things will not come back to haunt you. So I sit here today and I stand in awe of God, because I understand and know that my fight is fixed, yes, that I can live a life of victory no matter what. It doesn't matter the storm, the circumstance, the test, the trial, the tribulation, whatever comes up against you. You ladies, you women have to know that your fight is fixed no matter what. Face it to fix it and know that the fight is already fixed. The battle is not yours, it is the Lord's. Know that you are more than a conqueror. Know that God has you in all of this. In all of this, know that you have the victory and that the fight is fixed. Many blessings to all of you in this conference. I truly pray that you have received something out of this short message. If nothing other, know that your fight is fixed. Blessings to all of you.
Vanessa, thank you so, so much. If that's you, and you're sitting here contemplating what you should put on that vision board, she is a wonderful example. She said the fight is fixed, so she's a fighter. Are you ready? We are ready for our next sponsor. And I wanna go back over to Hilton Jones Media. And the reason I'm saying that is because Vanessa just blessed us with our fight being fixed. And what is it that's on your vision board that needs to be fixed? What is it on the heart that you can have? And while we are dealing with the media, what she's actually available to do for you is to help you get your vision going forth. She's to help you with your marketing. She's to help you with everything that it is that makes your vision so you can see it. It says to write the vision down and make it plain. And we know that Hilton Johns Jones, I'm sorry, media is there to meet every need. Media, public relations, media seminars, media coaching, corporate communication training, crisis changing, social media. So just like Vanessa was there and didn't see a future, God said he knows the plans and thoughts he has for you. So take her testimony and put it together with what's available for you through Johnson Media and meet your needs. Isn't that exciting, guys? I am so excited about that. Let's go to our speaker number.
Denise.
Two.
I just want to jump in real quick, Pastor Denise. I just want to say that Ashton said we're streaming live in South Africa, Nigeria, India, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Sierra Leone, Zimbabwe, Ghana, New Zealand, UAE, Botswana, Eswatini, and many other countries around the world. Ladies, y'all are international. Woohoo!
We are global. We are going global. We are global. So, you know, it's exciting, Pastor Chris, because it lets us know that as women and men, we're not alone. That, you know, all of us fighting together, that is so powerful. What, you know, one could put 1,000 to flight, two could put 10,000 to flight. Can you imagine what's ahead of us as we connect with all these people all over the world? And by speaking about that, I wanted to go with Kenyatta Collins. Now, you know what, guys, as we set our goals and objectives on that board, we want God's word says above all things, he wished that we would prosper and do what? Be in health, even as our soul prospers. And what confidence can we have in somebody that we can trust? Well, Kenyatta N. Collins was born November 16, 1982 in Louisville, Kentucky. She attended the University of Louisville, graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts degree in political science in 2015. She made the move to the state of Georgia in 2011, where she now resides with her husband, Chuck, and her beautiful daughter, Liberty, in McDonough, Georgia. She received her Bachelor's of Science and Master's of Science in Nursing from Clayton State University in 2014 and 2019. Kenyatta currently works as a reputable nurse practitioner in McDonough. So guys, if you're from Georgia, you can get to her. Her dream is to start and put everyone in a healthy mood and also have her own company. So with that being said, one of our amazing sponsors, Ms. Kenyatta Collins.
Write the Vision annual vision board party. I'm super excited to be here. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Kenyatta Collins. I'm a nurse practitioner, I'm a wife, I'm a mom, I'm a life coach, you name it. I got that hat in my closet. Anyways, I'm not gonna keep you ladies long. Just want to share a few points on how to stay healthy for the upcoming year. 2020 has done us all in, but it's okay. 2021 is changing things. And let's just speak about a few things we can all do. First off, let's visit the doctor at least once a year. Check in with your doctor. It doesn't have to be me. Be whoever you feel comfortable with, but just say, hey, I want to come in for a physical. I want to get a complete physical. What all does it look at? We can look at your thyroid function, your kidney, your liver, your glucose levels, your blood pressure, your risk for diabetes. All that can be established just from a physical. Knowledge is power. The more we know, the better we can do for ourselves. Dietary changes, lifestyle changes, however you want to see it. Going along with that is management of stress levels, because what we may not be aware of is increased stress levels weigh physically on the body if not attended to. You may increase your blood pressure, you're increasing your migraines, and decreasing your risk, you know, decreasing ability to have a good night's rest, which then also creates havoc on the body. So it's all interconnected. Stay aware of yourself, get a good hobby, journal, do some kind of a way to elevate your mood. And a good one, whether you know it or not, is exercising. Exercising releases many, many hormones in the body that can have shown to be proven to elevate your mood and increase strength and, you know, durability and mental focus. Everything can be attached to that. So whatever you need to do, get yourself out there, get motivated, get moving. If you're really into cooking, you know, I recommend more people cook at home. One thing with COVID, it has absolutely given people the more opportunity to cook at home, to enjoy family time. I challenge you to try a new meal each week. There's a million, you know, recipes out there and websites to check out, but there's a lot of kosher-free, gluten-free, fat-free, cholesterol-free, all kind of recipes that you can try for yourself and your family. Get the whole team involved. Try something new each week as a challenge. Mark it on the calendar, and I'm going to talk about this calendar quite a bit, but mark it on the calendar and stick to it and just, you know, keep moving forward, keep moving forward, keep moving forward. Another thing we should do is limit our alcohol. Women, you know, ladies, we all like to go out and have brunch with our girls. We want to celebrate, and that's fine. But for some of us, alcohol may be something that you might want to not have so much of because it can damage the kidneys and the liver, which help detoxify things in the body. You don't want all those toxins building up in your body. So if you can just go on and maybe limit, you know, this time I'm going to have one drink, not two or three drinks at this event, or join the Sober Curious movement, which is many people saying, I'm not going to drink for this whole month or these 2 months or these 3 months. And at the end of that Sober Curious movement, you actually decrease the amount that you're drinking within the course of the year overall. So it's still benefiting you if you're not quite ready to quit drinking, but you do want to limit your alcohol consumption. The other end of things is those who are smokers. It's not a good thing for your body, and I'm sure you're aware of that. I'm sure you already know how it damages the organs and the vessels and the heart, the kidney, that everything is damaged when you smoke. And this could be your year to stop smoking. All you have to do is put it out there on a calendar and believe it. It starts here. Mark it down and say, you know what, this is my year. As of today, I'm no longer smoking. And you don't have to do it alone. There's many, many medications. There's different things you can do. There's mind practices that you can do, and just bring it all in to where you believe and you see yourself as a non-smoker, and it will come to fruition. It's not easy for those who have been smokers, but you can definitely do it. And like I said, there's medication that can help along the way. Now, far as how you can do this and how you can hold yourself accountable, I have to wake up at like 4 o'clock in the morning most days when myself and my husband are trying to work out, and it's hard. The bed is comfortable 4 o'clock in the morning. So get yourself an accountability partner, someone that you can hold, you know, help hold yourself accountable. Say, you know what, let me check in with you once every week, once every 2 weeks, and this is what I've been doing, this is what I messed up on. And you know what, if you mess up, tick, that's okay. There should also be something, as I call it, a little punishment for myself. If I can't hold myself accountable, then maybe I don't need to go shopping this week. Maybe I don't need to buy something I really want to buy right away. Maybe I'll make up for it the next month or the next week. That kind of thing. So that way, you know, give and take. If I'm doing well, I'm going to reward myself at the same token. So get yourself an accountability partner. Join you a virtual club. Get you a virtual walking group. Get some people in the neighborhood that you feel safe around and say, hey, let's meet up and let's go walking. Find you a safe trail. Let somebody know where you are, but find you a safe trail. Get out there and get moving. 2021 doesn't have to be a repeat of 2020, and I by far do not believe that it will be. But get out there, get moving. I wish you the best of luck. 2020 is going to be your year. Claim it here, believe it here, and know He is going to make a way for it. Hello.
Thank you, beautiful lady. One of the things that I love about Kenyatta is that she's actually teaching us self-love. And if you're getting things ready for your vision board, a lot of times you just concentrate on pictures. But what I do, if I don't have pictures in magazines, is I write words out. So you can write the word health out for yourself. You can write goals and objectives for the amount of weight that you choose to lose. You can write out words like self-goals, health, self-love. These are things that she talked about. And if your husband's watching and he's kind of leaning off, make sure he comes back again, because not only is she a certified life coach, but Kenyatta has a company that she co-founded with her husband called 2020 Enterprise LLC. And it is a shipping, trucking, real estate company. So, you know, there's power in doing things together. And I love the fact that she said she got up with her husband. You may say, I don't have a husband. Well, get that bestie so you can get yourself in a position for accountability. Now, one of the things that Chris wanted us to do is she wanted us to give away some giveaways. Are you guys excited? Now, you know, we got people all over the world, but you have an opportunity to give away. One of the things that she wanted me to do was to ask you a question. Now, if some of you have seen the feature by the Kindred Brothers called Overcomers, I need you to put in the chat box which leading character works in full-time ministry as a pastor. Let me know in that chat box if you know the answer to that. And boy, do we have some giveaways. Look at our giveaways, guys. I mean, you got the shirt that talks about you being beautiful, that shares for who you are. There's some nice looking pumps up there for you. And then a second giveaway we have is the Women of Color Are Dope, a nice tote handbag. And then we got pillows to remind you to operate in forgiveness, to operate in loving yourselves and calling yourselves blessed. So we have a number of giveaways together. And then of course, you gotta know that we're gonna also let you have a Light in the Storm book. I mean, we've got you ready. We've got you ready. And guys, you know what? We even gonna talk to, Pastor Scott there, because you know she has a new best-selling book already out there, and we got to give that away to you too, because we're all over the world, so we need to know, we have to support each other. I heard her today on live talking about supporting each other, supporting each business. So do I have anybody? Let me check the chat. Did anybody put anything?
Pastor Denise, we can give away two items right now to the first two correct answers. Uh-oh. Okay. And while we're doing that, our video is ready. I want to show you. So Christine's going to go ahead and play the video and then you'll announce the winner. Go ahead, Christine, with that video. Pastor Denise, you excited?
I didn't know anything about this, guys.
I know. Christine, we're not hearing it.
They're recyclable.
I don't care if it came from the winding cloth that they wrapped my Lord in when he died. I'm with Calvary. And you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Okay, that's our fierce actress, Denise Armstrong. Just run it from the top because we missed that whole first part because of the volume. Thank you.
What you doing here?
Just telling people about Triumph 2.
About the church that's going up down the street.
Yes, ma'am, that's the one.
Does Bishop know you're here recruiting?
Oh, I'm not recruiting. I'm just letting folks know there's an option. I'm giving out mugs.
I don't need a mug.
They're recyclable.
I don't care if it came from the winding cloth that they wrapped my Lord in when he died. I'm with Calvary. And you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Thank you, Christine. So in honor to you, woman of God, Pastor Denise, just an amazing job. And you are just a pleasure to watch on the big screen, my sister. Thank you so much. And you know what, Pastor Denise, go ahead and announce soon as DJ Candy gives us a little quick introduction for your telling us who the winner is. Just real quick, DJ Candy.
She's just a girl and she's on fire.
Come on, y'all, get up on your feet.
Hotter than a fantasy, lonely like a highway. She's living in a world and it's on fire.
So Denise, wouldn't you say these ladies are on fire just because they're here?
Yes,
she knows she can fly away. Oh, she got 4 feet on the ground and she's burning it down.
okay, I'm not seeing the answers, but what I will say is that I saw the lady that was the first person to log in. Her name is, well, Aunt Susan, everybody. Aunt Susan logged in at 5:05, guys. You know, when you show up and you're on time, we got one lady that's going to teach you about being on time. And I just would like to say, let's give our first gift to Aunt Susie, because she was one of the ladies that showed up on time.
And I'll tell you too, Pastor Denise, the answers that we have Mr. Arnett. Kim Thomas was the first one to say that.
No.
Was that right?
Yes.
And someone else said the coach. The second person said the coach.
Nope.
So it's Mr. Arnett then.
Mr. Arnett.
Woohoo!
Cameron Arnett is
Cameron
in
Arnett.
Prime ministry. Yes, bring your own Bible baby. Full-time ministry. He and his beautiful wife, BJ Arnett.
And the second person, because we were going to give away two, that said it, is Judy Rogers.
No,
we won't give it to me.
Oh, no. Judy was in the movie?
No, Judy wasn't in the movie. Judy is part of our team, so she can't get it. She's disqualified.
Oh, okay.
Somebody, we're going to go for somebody else, Scott.
So our winner, please place your information privately in chat to Danielle, Scott, and she will make sure that you get your gift. Take it away, Pastor Denise.
Just one nugget, guys, for the movie Overcomers. Every lead actor in that movie is in full-time ministry. We added our faith that everybody that sat down and saw that movie, life would never again be the same. It was the number one family movie in America. So make sure that you share and watch and see that Judy Rogers, Coach Judy Rogers, that fitness Pilates coach lady tried to sneak up in here and get a prize. Now, you're not getting it. Okay, guys, we're going to keep things going. We got, are we going to get a little, some more music from DJ Candy? Or we're just going to go with our speaker?
You tell us if we're on schedule, either way, if we're on schedule, because we just need to be ready for Dr. Bailey at a certain time.
Okay, well, we're going to go with our speaker because we want to make sure that we're on time for Dr. Bailey. Guys, our next speaker, I'm so excited about this. I'm just not even going to say anything because I'm speechless because her testimony is speechless. But Renetta Nilsson is the CEO of Imprint Productions, Inc., a seasoned veteran in the field. Ms. Nilsson brings a magical skill to her team, key in consulting, key in helping. She has been in the development field for over 20 years. She gained her wealth and vast experience in developing industrial industry as overcomers, as an operator, as an owner. This woman's story, and she should be a story. She should be a feature. In fact, if you're writing and producing and directing, I think you need to get in touch with her, and her story needs to be told. I would never do it justice. Please honor and welcome Renetta Nilsson. I believe she's going to be live for us.
Hello, hello, hello. I am so honored to be here with you tonight. I want to thank God first for this opportunity. I want to also thank Scott for allowing me to be a part of this. And I thank our guest speaker. I thank everybody that is a part of this effort. I'm so in awe that we are streaming live to so many different places. Listen, as the owner of a multi-million dollar business, mm-hmm. and at the same time leading one of the fastest growing youth ministries here in Atlanta, I got lost in the success of that. Yes, I was lost in the success of that. And when there was an opportunity to respond in a critical moment that I had to face, my response was devastating. Let me tell you, we came into a fight with one of the local banks here in Atlanta, whom we settled with, and I'm not obligated or I don't have the rights to release their name, but we got into a fight with them and they wanted to take some real estates that we owned, and we was not having that. And so in the midst of that fight and fighting for 9 months with them back and forth and running through $1 million cash and getting down to our reserves and our company, my sisters were day-to-day components of this business. And I tell you, running through that $1 million cash and looking at our reserves and realizing that we were down to our last $12,500. Now we were fighting a fight, so we were not really doing business, although we owned real estates and income was coming in, but income was coming in and going out as fast as it could come in, paying legal teams that were supposed to be the best in the business. And listen, I remember one night laying there asking God to give us the answer to what we were going through. But let me tell you, that bank ultimately settled with us. And I remember in particularly that God had said to my sister that I am going to fight this battle. I'm going to make that bank ashamed of what they have done. Listen, I began to try to take matters into my own hands. And again, we won the fight. But however, in the midst of me taking matters into my own hands and not waiting on God to solve this issue, it was the public that rose up to say, leave this business alone, leave this woman-owned business alone. And the banks backed down because they were beginning to lose money. And you know that when you begin to hit them in the pocket, they will definitely fall back. So that happened, but I couldn't wait for God to do it. So I took matters into my own hands and I ended up having to serve 3 years in prison. But let me tell you something. Let me inspire somebody today. And I don't know who I'm talking to, but let me tell you something. I remember the day that the sheriff took me to that prison location where I began to get medically examined before going off to serve time at Emmanuel's Women's Facility. I remember looking and saying, is this real? You know, the judge did not want to sentence me. The judge went back and forth in his chambers. He kept coming out and people were emailing him, calling him. People were showing up to the courtroom and pleading for my case and just not wanting to see me go to prison. But let me tell you, God had already decided. I cried. I rolled all over the floor. I wanted to die. Somebody said that she wanted to die. I wanted to die. I wanted to not wake up. I was living in shame, silence, and secret. And in that secret for an entire year, as we fought this battle, I wouldn't allow anybody to know what I was going through, but I was still getting up in that pulpit and still preaching the gospel and knowing that I had an issue that I had to deal with. And I tell you, it was as if God said, you made that bed, you lie in it, but go and do the work that I've commissioned your hands to. The church continued to grow, but every day, every time that I stood in that pulpit, I could not wait to leave and go to my car and cry. But I remember when the judge said that he was going to send me to prison. I remember the last service that we would have, that I would have to tell the people what was going on. And we all wept and cried and begged God, but God had already made his mind up. And so getting to the prison, I remember the chaplain and her aide and one of and the aide whom is in ministry today. I remember meeting the chaplain and being told that we've been waiting for a pastor. Let me tell you something. The service there went from a handful to in 2 weeks, they had to move the service to the gymnasium. We saw hundreds give their lives to Christ. We saw 68 to be baptized. Let me tell you something. In my mess, God still blessed. In my mess, God allowed me to do the work that he had commissioned my hands to. It was as if he said, because you're here doesn't mean the work is going to stop. You're going to do what I have commissioned your hands to. And let me tell you about this right here. I remember getting there and saying, God, how could you put me here with these people? And I remember God just crushing my pride and saying, I love them just as much as I love you. Changed my world, because I thought that I loved the people because I took care of people, because I threw money at their problems and their issues. But God allowed me to be in a safekeeping place where he would teach me how to love his people, where he would literally perform an open heart surgery, that he would give me the heart that he has for the people. And I remember the favor of God, even in the prison. I was allowed to write every day the book that I now have, which is entitled Stripped Naked, because properties were taken, money was taken while I was away in the prison. You cannot know the things that people took from me while I was away. But I tell you today, God had told me to just walk, to not look back. And let me tell you something, I've not looked back. I am now the thankful and grateful owner of Imprint Productions, Inc. We are publishing 15 authors in less than 9 months. I'm gonna tell you, the hand of God is on this business. I am just in awe because it took 25 plus years for us to build what I thought was an empire prior to, but God is doing this new thing with Imprint Productions, Inc. in a rate that I can't even explain. So I tell you today, what I want you to take with you today is that it is imperative to perform a heart checkup. It's imperative to keep pride away. Pride is so dangerous. It is true that first pride and then destruction. And then I want you to be genuine and keep a mentor. I talk about in my book that if I had had a mentor, somebody who was not in my pocket, that could not have a financial interest in me, but that they would have an interest in my well-being and in my my life for godly purposes, then perhaps the story would be different today. But I'm not blaming anybody. But I tell you today, I have a joy down on the inside that I cannot explain. And I just thank God for that girl that went in and died. And now the new me is alive and well and moving and running on to see what the end is going to be. So God bless you. And thank you for this opportunity to give you my testimony. God bless you.
Amen. Pastor Denise, you're on mute. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for that, Brunetta.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. So, you know, God can use you no matter where you are. You know, so much for saying that you're not called to prison ministry. God will turn that whole situation around. But, you know, as I was listening and I thought about it, it reminded me, Pastor Scott, she was on a mission. It reminded me she was on a mission. It may not have been the thoughts that she had, but evidently it was the thoughts that God had. I'm not saying that God put her there, but God took her situation and turned it around. So if you're out here today and you're looking at things and counting yourself down and self-talking yourself in a negative way, what a testimony that God can turn that situation around. And maybe you may not have a mission of going to prison ministry. But you know, one of the things I love about Chris Scott, she's got that mission. She's taking people all over the world. She's showing people things that they may have questioned about themselves, like God can use them. Pastor Scott, can you tell
us? Amen. Amen. I am like truly, truly excited, Brunetta. That was truly amazing. And it's funny how God will put us in a position, ladies, that we don't expect him to, and how he's going to come. They had a need in the prison, and you went and you fulfilled that need. So many lives were saved. And that's why we can never look down on people, because here you were now in a situation with those people that you were helping and thought that you were probably their saving grace. But God, and you came out better than you went in Jesus' name. And Brunetta, there's so many people encouraging you out there. Ladies, I hope you're writing your vision, all this good stuff, all these testimonies. Write that vision and make it plain. We're going to go on into 2021 vision ready. So I want to open up this opportunity. If anybody, and I think you have the option to raise your hand, but if you've ever been interested in missions, in going on the missions field, visiting Africa, going to different places, the Caribbean, going over to Europe, if you're interested in missions, we have some missions opportunities coming up, some training for women in missions. And I want you to go ahead and message Renata or Danielle on here and say yes to missions. So if you're interested in missions training, and if you know God has called you to go, please go ahead and put yes to missions. And we'll reach out to you about our next missions training coming up very soon, because we have some places on the list that we're about to go to. If you're local here in Atlanta and you want to continue to help us with the homeless, here is Renata is going to tell us a little bit about what we do with the homeless. And I'm so excited about what God is doing. Thank you, Sharon, for saying yes to missions. And the ladies will get your information and we'll reach out to you. So go ahead, please. And Renata, tell us a little bit about what we're about to see.
Hello, ladies. Welcome. When it comes to missions, with Coaching Forward International, I am also a certified life coach. And for Coaching Forward International, you can find us on Facebook. But what we do is, what we've been doing this winter is going out, feeding the homeless, clothing the homeless, and also praying for them. So if you're interested also into looking into the life coaching and also volunteering your time, we usually go out on Sundays. So if you're interested, please go on Facebook and look up Coaching Forward. We'll be excited to have you on our team.
Awesome. And Christine's going to play that Coaching Forward video for us. And while she gets that set up, again, please remember you can give to the homeless, you can give for us to go, or you can come join us on Sunday mornings. And go with that video, please, Christine. This is our one of our outreaches, I think month before last, where we gave out over 300 blankets. We went into the trenches, under the bridges, and just different places in Atlanta. No volume on it, Christine. I'll be the volume. So we made sandwiches, snacks, gave out a bagged lunch along with a warm blanket that many people donated, and went out there and they were grateful, gave out apples, as you see, and just went into the trenches. We stayed safe, of course, so we always keep your safety first. We have men that go out with us to be able to make sure that we remain safe. And we're always collecting for the homeless, and they tell us what they're in need of. It's very important to find out what their needs are. And we pray with them, as you see that lady there on the ground. So there's even Kenyatta, our nurse practitioner, went out with us, who's also part of Coaching Forward, but we went out to the streets of Atlanta. So if you're interested in some of that work that we do and you want to join us, please also put that, send that to Danielle or Renata. And Coaching Forward International is on the move and just out there doing some really, really great things. And I'm going to turn it back over to Pastor Denise. Hey, ladies, how are those boards coming along? You got your cutouts ready? Make sure you have those cutouts ready. On there, we should already have some cutouts for our health and different things like that. So come on, ladies, let's do it. There's about 200 of us on here, and this is truly amazing. So even if you're not physically doing your board now, write down the notes, and God will be imparting things in you to tell you what that vision needs to be for 2020. Don't think that, oh my goodness, so much has happened in 2020, 2021. I don't know what's going to happen. No, you write that vision and make it plain, because we are told in Habakkuk 2:2. Let me stop preaching. Denise, Pastor Denise.
I was going to be right there with you. I was going to hands up on that one, Pastor Chris, because you know what? You're saying, well, missions, I don't know if I'm ready for missions. How can I support missions? You can always support missions by making a contribution. You can always support missions by listening to our next speaker, Dawn James. I'm telling you how you can work with missions. Dawn James is a business strategist, educator, mentor, and author. Since 2010, Dawn James has helped hundreds of authors fulfill their dreams of becoming a published author. I'm going to say a published best-selling author. I'm going to say, as a best-selling author, you can take some of those proceeds from selling that book online and support our missions. There is nothing quite like seeing your name in print, and Dawn cherishes the relationship she builds with each of her clients to meet their quest to become a published author. Dawn is founder and manager of Director of Publish and Promote, a company dedicated to teach you the business of being a successful author. With Dawn's expertise and business savvy, she has assisted authors in all aspects of publishing processing, from landing TV and radio interviews to becoming a paid speaker, being an author, best-selling author, and launching new products and planning new global goals. Please welcome and listen to the beautiful Dawn James.
Christine, we're going to need to start that over because we don't have the vocal on it. We need to hear this. This is some good information.
Good day, beautiful people. How are you? This is Dawn James. I am so delighted to be part of the 2021 Vision Conference. I met Chris a few years ago at an event in Atlanta called Woman on Fire. And I can tell you, Chris is still on fire, encouraging and supporting so many people. She has a generous heart. I love her energy, and I'm so honored to be here with you today. My name is Dawn James. I'm the Managing Director of Publish and Promote. Our company, since 2010, has worked with hundreds of authors, teaching them the business of being self-published. And so, I wanted to share with you today a story I think would be really appropriate for our vision conference. This is a story about a little girl who loved to draw. She loved to sketch. She loved to build things. And her dad was an engineer. And around age 7 or 8, he would sit her down and show her the drawings that he was working on all the different equipment, 3D drawings and sketches and plans. And by the age of 10, she knew in her heart and soul she wanted to be an architect. And she got a little older and she went off to high school. When she got to high school, she was so excited to learn. Her high school offered drafting. Yes. And so she enrolled in drafting and she studied drafting for 3 years. But on her first day of class, the teacher came up to her and said, "Are you sure you want to be here? Do you know you're the only girl in this class?" And she said, "Yes, I want to be here. I love drafting." So she did it. 3 years, she studied architectural and engineering drafting. When she finished high school, she looked out into the world, and guess what? She didn't see anyone that looked like her that was an architect. There were no role models that looked like her. There were no mentors that looked like her. And so she put her dreams aside of becoming an architect. 10 years later, she was married, and her husband had an opportunity to hire a builder. They had bought some land, and guess what? Her passion and joy of designing came back, and she designed a home. The builder built for her and her family. She went on to design and build 4 more homes over 20 years. The 5th home that she designed and built, I am sitting in it today. That little girl was me. I had loved architecture for as long as I can remember. And when the opportunity came, I jumped in both feet. And it's been such a joy to actually do something that I love to do. I have also had another big joy in my life, and that's from writing books. I'm not only a publisher, I am an author. My first book was published in 2010 called Raise Your Vibration, Transform Your Life. Who knew this book would take me to 4 continents? It would take me to places I never imagined. I've spoken to thousands of people. I've spoken on huge stages, and I have sold thousands and thousands of books because I had the courage and support to write. So at this conference, I hope you will take in the guidance of many of the speakers today, take in the inspiration, the encouragement. The moral of my story is, even though that little girl didn't have a mentor or a role model, she kept that fire burning in her heart and she found a way to express her passion. So believe in yourself, support yourself with people around you who encourage you. It's very important. And guess what? No one, absolutely no one, has walked your steps. Your story is unique. And I truly believe your story can inspire, educate, and uplift others. As Minister Chris loves to say, your story is for his glory. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. I hope you take in all the beautiful wisdom and guidance and inspiration of Vision 2021. And if you are ready to put it on that vision board, I'm writing a book in 2021. Check out Chris's programs. She's involved in a couple anthologies. I've had the pleasure in 2020 of working on a few projects with her. Beyond the Smile, our company Publish and Promote, edited, designed, and distributed that book. And we're working on another book launching in January with 7 men called And Still Champion, which we've edited as well. So I encourage you to put book writing on your vision board. Speak to Chris about it. Let's make it happen in 2021. For more about me, visit my site, publishandpromote.ca, and have fun at today's event. Bye for now.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Guys, she said, Pastor Chris said, your story is his glory. Your story is his glory. If you're sitting back right now and you're thinking, I could do what those ladies are doing. Some of you could probably host better than I'm doing. But the bottom line is if you don't step out and you don't do it, you'll never know. And what an amazing thing to do. If they've been telling you talk too much and you need to tell everybody what to do, you might need to spend some time with Pastor Chris because she has a wonderful video on coaching forward.
And Pastor Denise, that's actually the video that we played a little bit ago, so we can move on. But Pastor Denise, I don't know about you, but I'm getting excited. I can't wait for Dr. Bailey to get on here. Today she gave me a word for like 45 minutes. We know Doc when she starts talking. So ladies, yes. Are you getting all excited about that?
We are very, very, very excited about it.
And you know, and Pastor Denise, if the ladies, if you're interested in writing a book, please message Danielle or message Renata on here, any one of them, and Ashley will take that information and help you put your story on paper. So I'm so excited. So make sure you put that on your vision board if you're ready to write. All righty.
You know what? While we're waiting, if your writing is not your thing, but you know you want to help people and you want to learn how to do nonprofits, Judy Forbin is the CEO of EdgePoint Consulting. Judy is a nonprofit management consultant who helps nonprofits become grant ready, fully funded. She has drafted winning grant proposals, which is not easy to do. And she manages grant awards totaling over $15 million for both large and medium-sized nonprofits. Her boutique consulting firm dedicated to help nonprofits grow and prosper. As leading several highly successful, fully funded programs and organizing here and abroad, presently my findings as conferences and foundations, she has made a decision to empower under-resourced nonprofits with the tools needed to grow and prosper. Please welcome Judy Forbin.
Good evening, and welcome to, of course, the Virtual Vision Board Conference hosted by the wonderful Chris Scott, who I've been honored to know for the past 2 years. We met at the Southern Crescent Women in Business Organization and became fast colleagues and friends as well. You know, we both hail from the same place in the Caribbean, and we've connected on that level, but also on a business level. I'm very interested in the work that Chris does with her community and looking forward to, in the new year, her building and growing her nonprofit. And so when she mentioned the Vision Board conference to me about 3 weeks ago, I was more than happy to be a part of the celebration. And so I decided what I would like to do this afternoon, because it's a Vision Board party, or conference rather. I know a lot of us at the end of the year, we make our plans and designs for the next year, and often they fall in the grass if, of course, we are not actioning them. And it may be in the vision of some of you here tonight that next year you may be wanting to start a nonprofit organization, or if you're already a nonprofit leader, you may be looking to scale and grow it in the new year. And so I wanted to share a little bit about what I do and how I could be helpful to your organization or startup organization in the new year. And so now I'm going to pause and share my screen so that you can get a quick overview of how I help the nonprofit community. So as I mentioned, my name is Judy Forbin, and I am the CEO and managing partner of EdgePoint Consulting, which is a nonprofit professional services firm. And let's share a little bit about who we are. So our boilerplate description is that we help nonprofit leaders to start and grow profitable nonprofits that fulfill their mission and provide maximum a nonprofit doesn't, it does not mean that you will not make a profit in your organization. And as a matter of fact, you should be striving to make a profit for your organization, as that is the primary way that you will be able to continue to grow and to serve the public. And so EdgePoint Consulting, we are dedicated to helping those nonprofits grow and prosper, because we understand that nonprofits do the important work of saving the world that requires an arsenal of skills and resources. And so we use our considerable experience and expertise in the areas of grant writing, program development and implementation, board development, and of course, grant readiness to help you effectively fulfill your organization's purpose, but always keeping an eye on the bottom line, as that is really the engine that moves the organization forward. And so a little bit about our services. I'm going to start with the grant writing and training, and I will say this to all nonprofit leaders and founders. Grant writing is one of those skills that's a must-have for your organization, the same way that you need a finance person or you need an operational person or a program manager. You need someone in the organization or some people in the organization who have grant writing skills. And to that end, our firm can either research grant opportunities and create grant proposals for the organization, but we can also provide expert insight on why a previous grant proposal has been declined, that in the future you're able to be competitive. And most importantly, we can provide grant training workshops for the organization. And as I mentioned, that's really one of the skills that your organization should have. And so I often counsel nonprofit leaders to invest with at least 1 to 2 people on their staff, knowing the basics of grant writing, because then what you're able to do is to create your own proposals, and then you can farm them out for an expert for editing, and just ensuring that you're presenting the best picture of yourself. So if you own a nonprofit, or if you run a nonprofit, or are looking to do that in the new year, that's one of the essential skills that your nonprofit should equip itself with from the very beginning. And of course, when people come in and talk about grant writing, we often recognize that not all organizations are ready to write grants. And so we use our proven metrics to assess your organization's grant readiness, how effective your programs are, and of course, your organizational infrastructure. And in response to that, we will then draft a comprehensive grant readiness program that's designed to transform your organization from wherever it is, your baseline, into a grant writing machine that is competitive and able to attract and retain money for the organization. One of our new and now core services is, of course, board development, because we believe at EdgePoint Consulting that exceptional nonprofit boards lead to exceptional organizations. And so our services will help you recruit, select, onboard, and train a capacity-building board of directors. Once you have a trained board of directors who are bought into your mission, they understand the role of fundraising, they are able to be an asset, an ambassador for that organization, we often see nonprofits grow and scale phenomenally once your board of directors have the right tools, resources, and knowledge with which to move forward. And to go back to the very beginning, of course, we help nonprofit founders start their organization. And to do that, we provide professional and affordable document preparation and consulting services for you to achieve your 501c or tax exempt status. And of course, the nonprofit startup process. And so this goes for anyone who is looking to start a nonprofit or has already, maybe I often meet clients who have a nonprofit that they started 2 years ago, but they've done nothing with it. And they'll say to you, you know, I really need to get this nonprofit on the road. And so we provide that start and scale up plan so that you can launch with integrity and launch with impact from the very beginning, as that is often the signal that will let you know that your nonprofit will survive those first 3 years that we learned many of the organizations that start, they fail in the first 3 years because they have untrained boards, because they don't have the capacity or the know-how to attract and retain not just funds, but also skilled staff that are interested in growing your organization. And maybe your needs as a nonprofit leader and founder do not fall into any of the buckets that I previously discussed, and you may need boutique services. So this is perfect if you have a unique organizational or management need, or maybe you're a nonprofit leader or founder who would like to sharpen their skills through intensive coaching. And research on this subject has shown that not just in the nonprofit world, but all throughout the corporate world, even in education and all those areas, we're finding leaders who are focused on sharpening their skills, becoming better leaders, because then they're able to mold their organizations, with help, of course, into organizations that are profitable and that meet their mission. And so if you are a nonprofit, potential nonprofit leader, founder, or if you are one and may have been in this work for a few years and you would like to upgrade your skills, we often create coaching packages that create specific goals that you'd like to meet, and we work towards them in a timed manner. So those are the bucket of services that we cover here at EdgePoint Consulting. In addition, sometimes there are clients who are the DIY type, like, I don't have time to meet with you, just let me know what to do and I can do it. For those clients, we have developed several courses and workbooks, digital products that can help you do many of the items that I mentioned here. There's even a nonprofit startup kit. The average price to start your nonprofit is going to be the minimum of $1,500 when you consider not just consultant fees, but also the start of starting a business. And I've even heard it go up to $10,000, depending on the type of nonprofit you're starting. So having a digital tool that allows you to do much of the work yourself is invaluable. There are also digital tools that help you with board training and developing your program, as well as doing grant readiness. So if any of those services sound like something that you would like to be a part of or get more information about, let me share how you can meet with us or find us. So where you can find us on social media, and just in general, this is our office phone number, and you can email me, which is the quickest way to get a nod at judy@edgepointconsult.com. We're also on the net at edgepointconsult.com. Our website is currently being refurbished for the new year, so we're there and present, but it may look very different in a month or two. And of course, I am on social media in a number of places, as I'm sure everyone here is, and if you're not on at least one social media platform, you better get on it, because that's the place where many people start, by getting the ideas that they need and finding out what's new in their industry by being a part of nonprofit sectors online. So I am primarily on Facebook and Instagram, and a little bit on Twitter. But on Facebook and Instagram, you will find my educational posts and videos. You will also find information sharing, polls about the nonprofit world, as well as what's happening now, so that as a nonprofit leader, you stay on top of the information and you're always prepared for what it means to your organization. So I am so happy to have shared this time with you. I will stop here and hand you over to Chris to continue. So have a great afternoon, everyone, and I hope to hear from you soon.
Wow, guys, did you see all that? That's why you have somebody to take care of this for you. Our sponsors have been amazing. We have, you know, it's amazing. Vivian Carley has adult care, and I love that because it takes care of our seniors and gives honor to our wisdom that's out there. We have Hinton Jones Media. Again, we thank them. We thank Judy Forbin again, and of course, Blooms by Kenyatta. We can't forget that. And talking about sponsors, it's a wonderful time to introduce our next speaker, who is Samantha Samuels, and she is also a sponsor, because Samantha, she is what we call a serial entrepreneur. She wears many hats. She's the president of Authentic Me, that would be me, guys, Consulting LLC, life and business coach consulting firm. She believes that your gift makes room for you, and everyone should find their authentic self. So if you think you're authentic, you need to put that on that vision board and call yourself what you want to be. She's currently the president of the Caribbean Association, Lord Child, let her tell you one thing, of Georgia, founder of Young Dreamers International. She has earned her bachelor's degree in organizing leadership and currently pursues a master's in mental health and wellness with the focus for family dynamics. She's earned several coaching certificates, life, transformational, purpose, entrepreneur, business coaching. She has appeared on several platforms, National Foundation for the Family, Children and Mental Health, Families Together in New York, New Yorker, yay sister, and so much more. She's a wife of 20 years, see, that helps, and a mother of three. She enjoys visiting the state park, being in nature. She believes that the closest thing to God is your greatest achievement of having a relationship with Jesus Christ. Please welcome one of our sponsors and our entrepreneur, Samantha Samuels.
At the Vision Board 2021, I am so excited to be here. All glory be to God first, and then I want to honor Minister Chris, Master Life Coach. I want to honor Dr. Bailey and all the other guests that are here. Today I will be speaking on maximizing your time management. My name is Samantha Samuels, and I am the founder and owner of Authentic Me Consulting. I am a coach. I am a business coach, a life coach, a mental health coach. I wear many, many hats. But today I want to speak to you about maximizing your time. And because someone like myself and Minister Chris and all of you that are in here have so many hats that you do wear, you want to learn how to maximize your time. One of the things when the Minister Chris called me and asked me to present here, I thought, oh my goodness, I am not the right person. But I want to share my story and my journey of how I have learned to maximize my time and still learning how to maximize my time. So maximizing your time. The value in a minute. What I have learned is the value in a minute. Understanding the value in a minute. Do you realize that there's 1,440 minutes in a day? Yes. So when you look at that number, you think, oh my gosh, 1,440 minutes in a day. So what is in a minute? What can you do in a minute? In 1 minute, God can give you an idea that creates wealth. Yes, he can. In 1 minute, you can do some jumping jacks or push-ups or anything to take care of your health. Yes, you can. In 1 minute, you can send about 5 quick texts to make things happen. In 1 minute, yes, you can. So one of the things that I've learned about maximizing your time is identifying your most important task, which is called the MIT. Identifying what is your most important task. So one of the things that I do is that I have a calendar in front of me that I am looking at right now that with dates, and those dates, they have certain things that need to be done within a time frame. So I'm going to look at that calendar and say, what can I do? How long will it take to get whatever I have on that calendar? Not only that, I am going to utilize my phone calendar as well. And then, you know, for some of you, keeping a pocketbook calendar as well. Work on things based on the importance of that thing and the due dates. So learning to maximizing your time is learning to work on that thing that's of importance. Remember, we talked about the MIT, most important task. And then complete most of your MITs in the early morning. Why do I say complete most of your MITs in the early morning? Because according to psychologists, your brain is more alert in the morning time. And so learning to maximize that time when you're completely alert, you are awake, you're jovial, that is when you want to utilize your time. And some people may say, well, I work in the midnight hour. That is in the morning time, right? But that is wee early in the morning. So whatever works for you, learning to use that time that fits when you know that you're completely alert, that you can get most of your important tasks done. I hope this is being helpful to you today. Master your lunchtime. I have learned, and I am still learning, how to master my lunchtime. So I have 45 minutes of lunch break. So this is how I break my lunch break down. Unless I have a really big, most important tasks to do, I break them up in 15-minute increments. And so my first minute, yes, I work from home. And so my first minute, I have it set on my calendar to take a power nap. You will be amazed of the importance of what a power nap can do. And in fact, my son taught me this about a year ago. He said, Mom, set your time for 15 minutes. No, don't make it less, don't make it more. 15 minutes, and that has worked wonders for me. In 15 minutes, you can work on an assignment. Remember, your MIT, focus on your most important task. And in 15 minutes, while you're doing your lunch break, stimulating your mind. Remember, you're writing a vision. So you have to stimulate your mind, listening to other motivational videos while you're eating your lunch, right? So I hope that helped. Maximizing 45 minutes. Now, this is a big one for me. Overcoming procrastination, my biggest struggle. So one of the things that I've learned how to maximize my time is to plan the night before. What am I planning the night before? I am setting my alarm. I am putting things in place. I am creating maybe a list. I am looking at my calendar. What is it that I need to get done? And how can I prepare to get that done the next day? Put your alarm outside of your bedroom or somewhere far away from you where you need to get up and get out of the bed. Because how many of you, you set the alarm goes off and you press snooze, snooze, and you go right back to bed. So in order to overcome procrastination, I put mine in either my office space or I put it way outside of my bedroom so I can get up and I can go right outside. And then the other thing that I do is that I know, okay, I need to get my devotion done. So I'm going to set my phone right next to my Bible. Isn't that awesome? Yes, maximizing your time. Set a time to complete tasks if you get distracted. So I am easily distracted. I will not tell you a fib and will not tell you a lie. So because I get easily distracted, I need to set a timer. So I may set 15 minutes down because I need 2 minutes break after 15 or 20 minutes. I get a task done, I take my 2 minutes, I get up, I walk around, do something quickly, and I get back to another 15 minutes. Remember, maximizing your time. And the other thing is, last thing is, never fail to have a notebook or a journal. So like I showed you earlier, I have this. So I always have it with me if I have something. Remember, I told you that God can give you an idea in one that can create wealth. So I always have a journal and a little sticky notepad to write on. Don't never fail to have a journal or a notepad, something to write, because God can give you a vision and an idea in 1 minute that can create wealth. So always have a journal and a notebook. I want to say thank you to Master Life Coach and to everyone that is presented here today. I am absolutely honored to have this platform. And I hope that you take one thing away from maximizing your time management. My name is Samantha Samuels, and I am your authentic meaningful life coach. Thank you all so much. Enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you, Samantha. Everybody maximize your time. And there's one woman that Pastor's going to introduce us to. There's no procrastination. We're really excited. She lives by maximizing her time. You better follow what Samantha says, and you better get your writing pad down to help you move on this vision board, because this is a woman that teaches that vision. Tell us about her, Pastor Scott.
Well, I am truly, truly excited as we get ready for Dr. Bailey. I've been here on the phone just because, you know, she's always doing something great. So I first want to say there are a couple of things that have been mentioned here. Mentorship is very important. So ladies, that should be on your board. If you don't have a mentor, make sure you get one. It's not always the best thing to be the smartest person in the room. have someone else that's where you want to be and where you want to go. So find yourself a good mentor in 2021, someone that's willing to sow into you with knowledge and great information. That's important to get you to the next level. I couldn't do it by myself. So find yourself a good mentor. And one of my amazing mentees, I call all my mentees queen daughters. Danielle is going to share a little bit of information about life coaching with you. Danielle? Danielle, you might still be on mute.
Good evening, ladies, and all of you that are across this wonderful world that we live in internationally. I want to share with you really quickly about life coaching. Many of us have been life coaches all of our lives without having the certification. Well, have no fear, you can get certified. If you have the gift of hospitality, if you have the gift of wanting to see somebody excel in life and help them to move their lives forward, whatever it may be, it could be the smallest thing of overcoming, I want to be a painter and I want to paint my house. It could be the smallest thing of being a painter. You can help them and move them forward to overcome that obstacle. I am a graduate. I graduated in August of this year, 2020, as a life coach. If you are interested in becoming a life coach, I love it. I have one good client right now since I've started my life coaching business. And I'm excited about her. She's an excellent client. It brings me great joy that I can use my story of what I went through in her in my life to help her overcome some things. And that's why we have stories. That's why we have experiences to help people overcome. You are an overcomer, and we can help others overcome that as well. You can, if you are the first 8 people today, you can go to globalconnectionsacademy.org. Once again, that's globalconnectionsacademy.org to register. If you are the first 8 people by January 1st, you will get $200 off your fee by January 1st. And also, real quickly, the next class starts January 23rd. Just wanted to let you know, January 23rd, January 1st, you get $200, the first 8 people. If you are interested, you can privately inbox me or Renetta or Ashley for more information. Thank you, Chris.
Awesome. Thank you so much for that. You know, I have to say, Pastor Denise, and to God be all the glory. As you know that I always say, all the glory, none of it belongs to me, but there's a special anointing on my classes. I have to say that. I look at the life coaches that have graduated and just out there doing some amazing things, just what God has placed in them, and they're able to enhance it and out there helping so many more people. Because truth be told, ladies, our gifts are not for us. They're for us to help somebody else. They're for us to be able to do the work that God has called us to do. And those of you that have the gift of encouragement, the gift of administration, so many gifts in you, it's time for you to leave no stone unturned and use them all in 2021. So let's do it. And I'll tell you, it is your spiritual assignment. So no longer holding on to those gifts that God has given to you. It's time to use every gift possible. So we have a video that's showing there, a quick clip. So the first 8 people, because we can only have 8 people in a class because it's via Zoom, go on. And we had Jadeen, I see that she's on here. She's in Trinidad and Tobago, and she graduated from the last class that we had. So we're so excited about that. But now, Dr. Bailey should be on her way in. So what I want to do right now is share some information about Dr. Bailey. We are so excited, who's our keynote speaker. But before that, I just want to say thank you again to our amazing sponsors. These are just amazing sisters to me. Vivian Crawley. Vivian Crawley actually started her business, I think, at the age of 70. and she has that business where she's caring for the elderly. So I'm so excited about her. And she said, sis, I am going to sponsor this event, because we know that no matter what, even though it's Zoom, it takes money, right? Somebody say it takes money. So Henton Jones Media, she's my publicist, Kalia, just truly amazing. She said, I'm going to sponsor. And Bloom by Kenyatta. Kenyatta was one of the amazing speakers. And also, Kenyatta is my doctor. She keeps me straight. So I thank God for her in my life. And she's also one of my queen daughters. And Samantha Samuels, just an amazing, amazing woman of God. Love her dearly. Thank you for sponsoring. And she's an amazing coach. And if you're looking for a coach, she can definitely help you along. And her company's called The Authentic Me and Coaching. And then we have Judy Forbin. Judy helped me start Coaching Forward International Nonprofit. So if nonprofit is on your page, please go ahead and definitely get it going and call Judy. She walked me through and she trained all of my people as well. So Kenyatta sits on the board and we have some other people that sit on the board. So I'm excited. But right now, I'm going to go ahead and read Dr. Bailey's bio to you. I could just tell you about her, but I'm going to be official. Ladies, are we writing those vision boards?
Right.
Are we putting all that information together? You ready? I know I have some things that I'm believing God for in 2021, and I'm about to write, and I'm jotting down as each of these ladies speak, and I hope you all are doing it as well. You know, Pastor Denise, we always leave ourselves for last, so I hope you're jotting some stuff down too, because God has so much for you to do. Look at you. Look at you. Come on now. Come on now. So, yes, amen. Amen. So I want to tell you a little bit about Dr. Bailey. She is my amazing, amazing mentor, and I love her so dearly. So let me just get that information for you. Now, our very own Dr. Bailey, she is a lecturer, author, founder of Master's Touch Ministries Global. She has been to over 147 countries around the world. How many countries y'all been to? We're about to go global, y'all. 147 countries. And all of those countries that we're broadcasting in right now, she's been to every one of them. So we thank God for her bringing deliverance, healing, and salvation to countless thousands. Dr. Bailey and her team have provided disaster relief in Haiti, right here in the United States, Hurricane Katrina, Hurricane Sandy, helped with the Flint, Michigan water situation. And she served as a consultant to the United Nations, head of the nations and head of states, diplomats and governmental dignitaries. She was also featured on the cover of Charisma magazine as a premier missions consultant. She attended Victory World Missions Training Center, New Life Bible College, and received not just one, but master's degrees and from Mount Olive Seminary and a doctoral degree as well from Cornerstone Christian University. She also received the Azusa Award for Global Leadership and the Presidential Lifetime Achievement Award presented to her by President Barack Obama. Shortly, you're going to hear the voice of my mentor and my big sister, Dr. Patricia Bailey. But for right now, we want to introduce my friend from South Africa, Simone van Niekerk, a saxophonist. So roll that video for us, please, Christine. As Christine gets that ready, y'all having a good time? Woohoo! I'm ready for 2021, y'all. But 2020 is not over yet, and there's some stuff that you still have to do now. It's the video with Simone. Pastor Denise, you having a good time out there?
I'm having a good time. I'm sitting here taking opportunity to write down my notes.
Repeat that for us. That was the right video, Christine.
I said I'm writing down my notes. I'm making my little points.
Oh, yes. I love it.
Greetings to all. I am Simone Benika from Pietermaritzburg, South Africa. And I just want to say thank you so much to Minister Chris for allowing me this opportunity to minister to you ladies today as you write the vision for 2021. I pray and hope that you guys will be blessed by this. And have a wonderful new year. God bless you. Thank you. Greetings to you all. I am...
God, lift your hands wherever you are, whatever part of the world, and worship God right now.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Back to you, Pastor Denise. We're waiting for Doc to come on. She's coming. But I think we should give something away.
You want to give something away?
Yeah, I feel like giving something away.
Okay. I want to ask the first person that can give us one of the steps that Dr. Kenyatta told us on health for ourselves for 2021. First person that comes up, but one of the nuggets she gave us so we can start with ourselves.
Health, take good care of your health.
Yes.
One step at a time.
Okay, well, that's the winner. Who is this beautiful lady? She came in, she got it. Did you see that, Dr. Scott?
Who is it? What's the name?
Judy. It's me. It's me. I'm guilty.
Julian Walker. Okay. So Julian Walker, somebody take her name down, please. Eating well. Thank you. Congratulations.
I thought you wanted us to put it in the chat.
It was supposed to be placed in the chat. So let's do this. Let's do this. Whoever was first in the chat, Pastor Denise and Julian Walker, will be winners. Okay. They are winners. Everybody's a winner. You get a prize. You get a prize. Awesome. Y'all forgive me. You know, I could be a little comedian here, but let's see who was first in the chat.
Looks like Lydia.
Lydia Rose, who was first? Ladies, I need you to tell me, my team, tell us who was first in the chat. Dr. Bailey's in the house, y'all, so we got to hurry. Tell us who was first in the chat. So Julian will win. And when my team inboxes me, who was first in the chat to get the answer?
Yeah, right.
I think I was, Chris.
It was Lydia Rose. Okay. Mm-hmm. Lydia Rose. Hi. All right. Congratulations, Lydia.
Thank you. Hey, Kenyatta.
So ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you, thank you all for what you're doing on here. All of you amazing speakers, all of you ladies, I need everybody to go ahead and make sure they're on mute because the woman of God is about to bring the word and I'm about to take this life-changing word and run with it. So make sure that you're on mute. Ashton, when you are ready, you can roll with the video. And that's the only video that we're going to play. Christine, Ashton's got it covered. So we won't play ours. Ashton, whenever you're ready. You can roll. Hi, Dr. Bailey. I know you're on. Love you. We are ready for a word.
Master Such Ministries for over three decades has been an impact around the world, reaching out to masses, many of the unreached, unengaged, the downtrodden, the forsaken, God's lilies. God has used us to bring total transformation during times of the famine in Somalia, where we were able to go in against all warnings of our government and bring Plumpy'Nut to babies that were starving and dying in the desert. 29,000 babies dying within 3 months' time, and we got a charge and a command to go in. And by God's grace, and for our partners and viewers like you, we've been able to go in and bring total transformation, bringing babies at the very brink of death and transforming them into a vessel and a beacon of life and light. One of my most favorite opportunities have been when we had the privilege, invited by the president and the ambassador at large, to go into Western Sahara, a little tiny, remote African nation in Northern Africa, 100% Islamic, there in the Sahara Desert, over 130 degrees scorching heat and freezing at night, we had an opportunity to bring young girls a literacy center and a training and learning center so that young girls in Arabic Muslim countries can have an opportunity to be educated and go to school and now break the systemic chain of poverty. Did you know that 130 million children have never entered a classroom? We're transforming the lives of young kids and children around the world that have never had an opportunity to go to school, neither their parents or their parents' parents before them. And these young kids can go to school for $80 a year. MTM has given them an opportunity to be educated, to stimulate their learning, and our curriculum deals with integrity, character development, and accountability, and nation changing, challenging these young people to understand who they are in Christ Jesus. When the typhoon hit in the Philippines, we knew that we had to move. There wasn't a question ever about our response to go. We were able to earmark pregnant women, babies, and mothers. 82,000 babies were about to be born in the month of January without clinics, without hospitals, and we were able to go in and bring prenatal care and to bring vitamins and clean water to provide for the mothers and the babies. We thank God that we were able to be the hands, the feet, the arm of God extended to those in many remote villages where no one had come. There was no food, there was no aid, there was no help. Total transformation, bringing absolute gospel, the gospel and the light and the love of Almighty God, allowing our light to so shine amongst men that they may see our good works. And in those remote villages, Buddhist villages, Muslim villages, as our light shined, they were able to glorify our Father who is in heaven. There is no place like Southern Sudan. And by God's grace, we were able to go in the midst of all the turmoil, and go to the waste, the ruined places, and transform nations into Garden of Eden. The Word of God tells us in Psalm 61 that we are to take former places of desolation, the old waste places, and we have the power to turn them into the Garden of Eden. Through our water projects, I'm so reminded in 2 Kings, the second chapter, the Bible talks about the city whose water was contaminated. 1/4 of the world does not have access to clean water. A 5-minute shower is more water than most people in developing countries have access to in 7 days. We're bringing transformation in remote villages like Agosito, Togo, where the village chief and all of his elders were willing to give their lives to the Lord because of a simple, simple, simple gesture of kindness by providing clean water. We thank all of those who have partnered and prayed with us and made all these efforts where we've been able to go in and literally be nation builders, strategists, solutionists, repairers of the breach, restorers of paths to dwell in, history maker, world changers. It's because of all of those who've partnered with us. This is who we are. This is what we do. Master's Touch Ministries, this is who we are and this is what we do, bringing total transformation to the nations of the earth.
Okay, ladies, I'm waiting to see me. Can't see me yet, Ashton. But ladies, whenever I can see me, this is who we are and this is what we do. I know that we're unmuted. And the way that we've been able to do all of this is through vision. Now, Minister Scott, I created this customized backdrop, mm-hmm. green screen, everything just for you, for your Vision 2021, because we're taking your ladies from 2020 to 2021, and any men that are there too, because we're equal opportunity employer, okay? We don't bash men. Well, ladies, we've been so excited about this, had a little bit of technical difficulties, and I'm like, Satan, we don't have time for your foolishness, not today. So we want to just, everybody, buckle your seat belts. It's going to be a quick few moments. I'm going to lean this way sometimes when I'm showing the illustration of that's you taking that leap that's going from 20 to 21. And so I want you to put this down coming out of the gate for 2021. I know there'll be all kinds of themes and expressions for 2021, but this is the one from Doc, okay? The best is yet to come for 2021. And you need to say that about yourself. Ladies, go on and release it out into the atmosphere. Release it into the atmosphere over your life, over your family, over your finances, over everything. And to enter into 2021 with vision. There's no better way than we don't really have an alternative, because what we've experienced, and I got to get it right, because it's usually backwards this, because so like this is like this here, so 2020, I keep saying 20, this 20, this right here, this is 2020. We are doing an X to it in a few days. And what we're getting ready to do to this 2020 over here, we're about to soon sing the song, so long, bye-bye. You can just say bye-bye to 2020. Because we are headed to 2021 with vision. That's what God put in Minister Scott. And so we're 100% behind that. I want to share with you how we've been able to do the things that we've done. Just, I'm going to be on a fast track because I have a limited amount of time, but I had no choice. And most of you that are watching had no choice but to literally be innovative and create vision. You had to create vision. You had to see what you couldn't see, because many times it was not anything tangible for us to put our hands on. And in this 2020 year, I decided coming out of the gate when the pandemic hit, when it was exposed to us, I said from the beginning, ladies, and this is all about vision, I decided I am not going to let fear grip my heart. I don't care what, and I don't like to say I don't care. I put it this way. It doesn't matter what other people think or believe or how they choose to deal with what's coming for this, at that time, 2020. I decided, as for me and my house, and as for me, the covenant of God and the system that I have as a covenant with God, that the system I operate in is not this world system. And I'm not gonna let whatever happens detach me from the system and the kingdom of Almighty God. And that alone takes vision. Why do I say that? Vision number one, when God was speaking to Abraham, I have been so ready for you ladies today. I hope you can feel all this love coming through this screen to you. I hope you can feel this right here coming to you with love. I looked at when God was speaking to Abraham. Abraham didn't have vision. He had no reference point to be able to understand or see what God was articulating to him concerning the vision and the promise. So he says, this is what you're going to have to do. I'm going to help you. Now watch these steps, because you're going to do the same thing with your vision board, with your vision, everything, with your posters and your everything that you have. Listen to what he says to Abraham. I first need you to elevate. You need to go up to a high place, which means vision elevates us. He didn't say go to a low place. He didn't say go to a narrow place. He didn't say go to a limited place. And he didn't say go back to the place where you've always been. He said, climb this mountain, go to a higher place, which vision takes us where we've never been before. I need to elevate your thinking, because guess what? When you go higher, your vision sees more. You see on a higher level what you can't see on a lateral level of life or the level that you were operating on. Einstein says that you cannot come up with a solution with a problem on a higher level when you're trying to deal with that problem on the same level. Most people have been trying to deal with 2020 on the same level they dealt with 2019. You can't do that. You can't even go into 2021 on the same level of 2020. That's why you see the person taking a leap, okay? Every so often, I want you guys to just leap and lean with me. You ready? Leap. Come on, guys. One more time, because we're going over here. I want you to see that person leap. One, two, three. Come on. Leap with me. Come on. We're not staying where we once were. We're not staying over there. So he says, I can't get you to stay where you were. You cannot operate down here on this level with your daddy, Junebug, Pukenim, Ray Ray, Big Mama. You need to come and climb with me. You need to go up higher. You need to go up higher in your thoughts. You need to go up higher in your conversations. You need to stop having these narrative conversations around the dinner table and on social media, repeating and parroting what everybody else says. Come up here and listen to what I have to say. Come up here and let me show you what I have for you. Because if you will elevate and go up higher to let him show you what he has for you, you will see the windows of opportunities, that there is a time clock that's attached to what God has for you. Like, you mean to tell me I'm not waiting on God? God's been waiting on me. I could have had this business. I could have written this book. And the only thing that was standing in between me and what God has for me is vision. So he says, come on up, Abraham. And when Abraham got up there, he says, now I'm going to help you again. First, I had to get you to leave where you were, that low place to a higher place, that low place to a higher place, that low place to an elevated place. That's number one coming out the gate. Leave where you are in your thinking. Number two, look up and look out. Look up, look up. As long as you look up, you can keep getting up. Stop living life looking at things on a lateral level. Keep
looking up. I look up unto the hills from whence cometh my help. I lift up my eyes into the fields that are white unto harvest. I lift up. Why so downcast, O my soul? Hopest thou not in God? Lift up your head, you so downtrodden and heavily. Lift, look up and look up at the stars. I remember being in the Sahara Desert, and we were there with the same people you saw Western Sahara, people stranded in the desert. And one night I went out and it was nothing but goats and tents and camels, and the sky was so black like velvet in the Sahara Desert, and the stars looked like multitudes and multitudes. And I said, this is what you showed Abraham, Daddy, isn't it? This is exactly what he showed him. So there was nothing for Abraham to relate to, so he had to find something. He created a vision board for Abraham. Did y'all miss that? You mean to tell me that went shh? He's the first person to come up with a vision board, Minister Scott. Here's your vision board, Abraham. So shall your seed be. Can you number the stars? Can you see the stars? You can't number them. So shall your seed be. Here is your vision board. And then he doesn't stop there. He gives him another vision board. He says, let me give you another one. How many of you got more than one vision board? Raise your hand if you got more than one vision board. Come on with me, ladies. Come on, pull up. I need you to come up higher, because if you come up higher, you're going to get higher out of me. Then he says, now look at the sand. The sand. Can you number the sand? And Abraham was like, I can't number it. And he says, so shall your seed be. So shall your seed be. You can't even number it. That's how vast, that's how diverse, that's how broad, that's how big, that's how no limitations. So then he tells Abraham, then we see in Galatians 3:14, he says, you are the seed of Abraham and an heir according to the promise. So the same thing he said to Abraham, you are an extension of that same vision board. So shall your business be. So shall your increase be. So shall your peace be. So shall your health be. So shall your multiple streams of income be. So shall your franchise and making things scalable. It shall be multiplied. It shall be enough. You can't measure it. So there's your vision board. And what I've always done, Mr. Chris wanted me to do practical things. We just did. What perfect. We didn't even know when she asked me to do this that we would have something called a vision house, because the power of vision is so powerful. Let me show you how powerful vision is, ladies, and those of you that are watching from all the different platforms. First of all, I want to announce to everybody, we hit 5,000 today. We've been trying to get to 5,000 on YouTube. We hit 5,000. We hit it. Yes, we did, because we had a vision for it. You know, we kept seeing this is where we're going. So when Minister Scott asked me to minister, we didn't have the vision house. And this vision house, we didn't even know what to name it. All I know is that the opportunity came, because remember, I set my trajectory. When God took Abraham up to the mountain and allowed him to see what he couldn't see on a lower level, he was number three. I think I'm at number three by now. He set his trajectory. Number one, you got to leave where you are to go to an elevated place. Number three, you got to have a vision board, which is what he did with the stars and the sand. Number three, he set a trajectory for where he was going to go. So I had to set my trajectory for where I was going. And when the pandemic first hit, when we first heard about this pandemic, I was like, no, I set my trajectory. I don't know what anybody else does. What I mean, it doesn't matter what they choose or what they think. I'm not going there. I'm staying over here with the covenant. I'm trying to turn my little cute blue earrings around, because they're not really showing. And I put these little blue earrings on for you, Chris. I got these just for you and your ladies. I was trying to match my little blue earrings to match with my little vision. I'm trying to coordinate. And the thing turning around, and y'all not see. Can you see my blue earrings? I'm Theresa's child for sure, okay? So listen, he said, I got to set your trajectory, Abraham. Your trajectory was set by Jumba, Pookin, and Ray May, Big Mama. That can't be the trajectory for where I'm taking you. So in the beginning of the year, because I understand the principles of vision, write this down, bold caps, Understand the principles of vision. Understand the principles of vision. If you don't understand the principles of vision, if you violate the principles of vision, which means you sit around looking at negativity, sitting around looking at stuff on television all the time that's negative, negative, lack, scarcity, doubt, unbelief, what you fear shall come upon you. God doesn't play with fear. Revelation 21 verse 8, one of the first things he says is going to be cast into the lake of fire are people that are cowards. You can't let fear come in. You can't be afraid to dream. You can't be afraid to trust vision. So you set your trajectory. As for me and my house, we will dream bigger in 2021. As for me and my house, the best is yet to come. I set my trajectory. It doesn't matter what other people say, the doom and gloom prophets, how bad it's gonna be. Another wave is coming. It's gonna be 2022 before we come up out of this. The devil is a liar. Hey, it doesn't matter what they throw at us. It's not what you live in, it's what you let live in you. So in the year of a pandemic, because I was living in the pandemic, but the pandemic wasn't living in me, and I chose not to survive, I chose to thrive. A $500,000 vision house came and knocked on my door. Wish I had something to knock on. And here I was, my mind could have said, how in the world are you planning to try to do that at the end of the year, doing what they call the winter slump, when people pull back on their giving, how are you going to even think about even looking at a $500,000 property? Somebody say, but vision, put it in the chat. But vision allows me to see what I can't see. But vision allows me to see what I can't see. But vision allows me to see what I can't see. So let me show you what vision does and how vision is more powerful than sight. Helen Keller said that people felt sorry for her because she didn't have sight. She said, the person to pity is the person who has sight with no vision. Did you hear that? You need to tweet that. Well, first time you tell them Helen Keller said it, second time you say Dr. Bailey told you Helen Keller said it, okay? But listen, a person that has sight but no vision, now watch this. Let me show you that vision is more powerful than sight. Can't you tell I'm excited? I haven't had any coffee, any ginger or nothing. This is the power of vision. Everybody close your eyes. Everybody close your eyes. You're getting ready to see the power of vision. And this attribute is within you. And it's a gift from Almighty God. Every eye closed. Nobody cheating. Okay? Right now, whether your mother is dead or alive, I want you to see a picture of your mother. I see Mama T. I see her. I see her putting on lipsticks, putting on eyeliner. The way she always do, put her makeup on before somebody comes. Yeah, I see Mama T. You see your mother? When you see your mother with your eyes closed and you see her, raise your hand. You see your mother? Okay, everybody. If you have any kind of vehicle or some friend has a vehicle or somebody in the family has a vehicle, I want you to see your vehicle. If you ever had a vehicle, see that vehicle right now. I see my vehicles right now. I see both of them. Two black Porsche, an SUV and a Panamera. The Cayenne and Panamera, I see them. I see them. Okay, keep your eyes closed. Can anybody remember your first grade school teacher? Well, that may be a little bit too far back for you, so let's maybe do something quicker, easier. Your bedroom, your bed. How does your bed look? How did you leave it? What does it look like? Did you make it up today? What's your bed? What kind of linen is on it right now? What color are the sheets? What color is the comforter? What color are the pillows? Can you see your bed? When you can see your bed, raise your hand. Women of vision, people of vision. You see your bed? Now, open your eyes. You don't see with your eyes. You see through your eyes. You see with vision. Somebody need to shout better than, you know, I'm preaching better than you shouting, putting, chatting, amen. So if you can see your bed and you can see your car and you can see your mother, Why can't you see your debt-free life? Why can't you see that book completed? Talk to me. Don't leave me over here. Don't you act like I'm not speaking English to you today. Why can't you see a debt-free life? Why can't you see a healed body? For those of you battling with weight, why can't you see a skinny body? Why can't you see the husband? Why can't you see the children obedient? Why can't you see the company with multiple locations in other nations? Why can't you see your currency in British pounds, in Nigerian Naira, and South African rands and safers and francs? And why can't you see it? Because this vision, is one of the greatest gifts that God ever gave us. So this vision house, how am I going to get this house? What are you going to get the money from? No, those are the things that are vision killers. The vision killers are, but why? And but what? And then those vision killer people, what do you mean you got a vision to do this? The vision killers are cousins to the dream killers. They all eat at the same place. So guess what? You can't share your vision with everybody. So sometimes you got to take that vision and you got to hide it in your heart sometime. And you got to go in your room and have your vision board. And then guess what? You got to talk to your vision and you got to talk to that vision. You got to speak. Though it tarries, it will eventually talk back to you. You first start talking to the vision start talking back to you. They think you crazy anyway. Girl, talk to your vision. Guess what? I'd rather be crazy with a vision, crazy with a manifestation, than crazy and broke and crazy with nothing. They think you're crazy anyway. Go ahead on. Let's give them something to talk about. Talk to your vision and your vision will talk back to you. I took that house. Ashton put the pictures of the house up. Ashton sent me the pictures of the house. When Ashton showed me the pictures of the house, in my heart, in my head, keep flipping them, Ashton, in my heart, in my head, that's just the garage, guys, in my heart, in my head, in South Africa during a pandemic, in my heart, in a gated community, the Beverly Hills of South Africa, where the maids quarters, where the rich white South Africans, so the South Africans who had maids and that was ruling over our people. Are you hearing me? This little black girl from North Kakilaki during a pandemic, trying to figure out how you're going to get the money to go drop cash for this. But in my head, in my mind, in my heart, in my head, in my mind, in my heart, in my vision, I started talking to the house and I said, and this is what we're going to put in here. We're going to put beds here. And we're going to take the garage and turn it into a 2-bedroom and the pool. And this is what we're going to do. And I'm going to build it's got a gate around it and it's in a gated community. I want to build up a higher gate. And over here, I'm going to have Ashton, I want you, where you have these gazebos, the thatch roof gazebos. I want a thatch roof gazebo in. I want the kids to be able to play here. And I want to bring kids. That's the maid's quarters there. I want the kids to be able to come in over the weekend. And then I want the nannies that take care of the kids. I want them to stay in the master suite. I don't want them to want for anything. I want to pamper them and take care of them. And I want the kids to eat on china. I think we even have a picture somewhere. Yolanda, can you shoot that over with the china and the linen and the banquet table? And I want them to eat on that. And I want them to see that this is what God has for them. As a matter of fact, since we're talking vision, Ashton, show the vision video. Show it. I'm talking vision. I'm showing you how to get a manifestation.
There is a way to break the systemic chain of poverty. We're about to embark upon what I believe is going to prove to be one of the most impactful, life-transforming initiatives that we've ever done. It is our Vision House in South Africa, allowing young children from some of the most remote and impoverished townships, the challenges of crime-ridden neighborhoods, and looking around and seeing very limited images of a new vision, where we believe that we can transform their lives. As they come to the Vision House, they'll have an opportunity to experience opulence, a world that they've never seen before, and to let them know that this world is attainable. They'll eat on china, find linen tables and tablecloths, and having like the very best of the best where they're sleeping, where they're living at. There's a swimming pool and there's a whole out yard to play with. And then we're bringing in specialists that are sowing back into the lives of these young children that many grew up in townships just like this, bringing in pilots and doctors and lawyers and business women, and they can see people that look just like them that made it out of the townships. Creating a new vision for them is going to create a new life for them. You have an opportunity to transform their lives by creating a vision weekend for the kids there. I'm so excited about the opportunity of transforming them from a mindset of poverty into a new mindset, a life of not only opulence, but a life with no limitation. I believe that visualization brings manifestation. So here's your opportunity to transform the mindset of a life of a child forever. They may leave the vision house, but the vision will never leave them. The Vision House, where vision is created and lives are transformed.
I started speaking to the vision. Next thing you know, somebody will call and say, God told me to give you, I thought I didn't have 1,000, but God told me to give four. Someone says, I like that. I see the, I can feel it. Pastor Winston, my very own pastor, he didn't even know anything about this. Pat Mara called me from Living Word Christian Center and said, Pastor said to tell you, instead of sending you one check this month, he gonna send you two. I said, you talk to vision and then vision will start talking back to you. Next thing we know, somebody dropped $1,400 in their account. What? From who? Where? Somebody else. I was talking to this couple, hang up the phone, and they said, they sent a text and said, God told us we were going to give 2,000, but God told us to give you 25. And the money just started coming in because visualization brings manifestation. You need to write it down. Visualization brings manifestation. You think that you can't operate in what God has for you because where the money gonna come from? And I don't know how I'm gonna, shut up. I don't know how I'm gonna pay my bills. I don't know where the money gonna come from. I can't see, I can't figure it out. I can't see, you're not supposed to figure it out. It's not supposed to make sense. It's supposed to make vision. It's not supposed to make sense. It's supposed to make vision. The vision brings the resources. The vision brings the provision. Where he guides, he provides. Visualization brings manifestation. Visualization brings manifestation. Say it with me, say it with some say it like you're a victor. Visualization brings manifestation. Visualization brings manifestation. Once you see it, you can have it. Visualization brings manifestation. When God gave Yolanda the vision for Culture Kids, she started buying laptops and computers and this and that and no kids yet. When God told Mary that she was going to conceive the Son of God, she's not even showing yet. And then she goes to get with Elizabeth. There's no, the angel says the Holy Ghost shall come upon you and overshadow you. And she believed it. She believed the vision of what God said. She didn't have no morning sickness. Her back wasn't hurting. She probably didn't even realize that the minister was missing whatever. There was no evidence that this vision was inside of her. But she started speaking to the vision. She started carrying vision. And then eventually the vision carried her. Who am I talking to today? You feed that vision. You speak to that vision. You talk to that vision. You wake up and you say, good morning, Vision House. Hey, it's going to be a few more months and I'll be seeing you. Well, the first thing we're going to do is rip out the bathrooms and redo them. Don't worry about it. It's coming. And when we drop cash, I said, drop cash. When God dropped cash, I said, you mean to tell me that that house was inside of me and I didn't even know that house was in me? That house was in Val, that house was in Pam, that house was in it. Yeah, Yolanda, in a gated community. Are you hearing me? God, what's inside of you? What's inside of you, this vision that's screaming to come out, that's screaming to manifest? That's all I've ever done. The house in LA that we believed for years ago, the El Elyon house, the house of the Most High God, $250,000 in 3 months' time. What you send out from yourself, you draw back to yourself. So in the morning, I would look at the vision house. In the midday, I would look at the vision house. And before you go to bed at night, at least 15 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes before you go to bed at night, look at your vision every night. Look at a picture of your vision every night before you go to bed, because your human spirit does not know the difference between what's reality and the subconscious. And the subconscious is more powerful than the conscious mind. The subconscious mind thinks it's already done. The subconscious mind think you rich. The subconscious mind think you skinny. The subconscious mind think you smart. The subconscious mind think you can do anything. So align your conscious mind with your subconscious mind. That's why when you dream, you never fat. That's why you dream, you never broke. That's why when you dream, you never lose. You're flying, you're on top. You have this, you have that, because the subconscious mind doesn't know that it's not a reality, because it's a reality in the subconscious mind. That's where vision lies, where you can see your mother, where you can see your car, where you can see your bedroom. Start spending more time living in that realm versus this realm and dimension, which you think is the tangible, real dimension. You think this is more real, but that created vision world is really the real world. And you're not waiting on it.
is waiting on you. So we're going into 2021. Let me lean this up. That was 2020. Put me on a full screen, Ashton. And baby, we getting ready to leap and lean into 2021. Because the vision for 2020, honestly, that vision was really a little too small. And I just want to remind you of this. I just want to remind you that in 2020, during a pandemic, it was definitely a pandemic, paid cash for a house. Two young ladies that served the ministry paid cash for two Denalis. I said Denalis. I didn't say a Volkswagen. I didn't say a Vega. Paid cash. In 2020, widows fed every single month in Belize, widows in Malawi, water filters shipped to Botswana, taken to Botswana, in Lebanon, several times to expatriates that were left homeless and devastated even after the explosion. In Sierra Leone, Eswatini, Malawi, India, South Africa, several times. Just sending out thousands of dollars to prevent misfortune in the lives of others. We didn't have to back up off of missions. We didn't back up off of ministry. We didn't shut our bowels of compassion. We did more during this time of pandemic than we were doing before. Why? Because of vision. Look at the pictures. This was just last Saturday, 12,700. I think it's closer to 14,000 orphans fed because of vision, because of vision. There is no lack. There is no scarcity. The only lack and the only scarcity is what you create in your mind. There is no impossibility. It's only what you create in your mind. God gave you the ability that the brain, when it sees a picture, it polarizes that picture, sends a signal to the brain, and it's locked there in a file system. And you can pull it back up, and you can pull it back up. And every time you pull that file up, every time you look at it, and you speak to it, and you say, this is my vision, and this is my reality, and I will not live in 2021 like I lived in 2020. It's like that man you see, or that woman. This is a woman. This is a woman with a backpack on, making her leap. That's you right there, sister. Come on, let's get ready to lift and leap on the count of three. We're going into 2021 with vision, with no limitations, on the count of three. One, two, three. Come on now. We still counting down the days, but baby, my mind and everything is already in 2021 because the best is yet to come. That house manifest, all those missions projects manifest, the water filters manifest, feeding the widows manifest, feeding the orphans manifest. And these kids that come in, we're going to take that weekend, ladies, and create vision inside of them. And guess who's partnering with me as we take care of these kids, as we feed the homeless and those that are in Atlanta that need coats and blankets. And, you know, Minister Scott says that her storage is empty now because she's been giving out and giving out and giving out. And for us, we collaborate together in missions and in ministry. And I think that there's close to maybe at least maybe 150 women maybe on here. How many actually showed up? How many do we have, guys? Do we at least have 100? How many do you think we have on here?
I'm thinking about 150, Doc.
You think about 150 showed up? Okay. So listen, ladies. Let me tell you one part about vision. Remember I told you how you have to feed vision and then vision feeds you. And you speak to vision and vision speaks back to you. How did I thrive and pay for the house and feed all those orphans and take care of those people and pay people's lights bill, water bill, mortgage bills? How do we do all of that? When, listen, lean in. Can you lean in? Let me in on secret. Lean in. I wasn't able to work. I wasn't able to go out on the mission field. I wasn't able to go around the churches. I wasn't able to do that. I was stuck in this country. My revenue comes from going and traveling and going abroad and going around the churches. So I could have been just like any other person saying, I don't have a job. I don't have income. But I would not let that vision in my head. I wouldn't let it in. And so we never stop giving, because I live to give. And when you take care of the widow and the orphan, the homeless, the refugee, the stranger, God will take care of you. So we believe in God tonight. And listen, don't you dare. Remember I told you God hates cowards, and God doesn't, he don't like cowards. He doesn't like fear. He don't like scared people. Every last woman that I'm looking at right now, there's no reason why you got enough vision and enough faith. We're not asking for anything crazy to be able to bring those kids to a vision weekend, feed the people up under the bridge, provide coats, and the women want bras and our pantries are empty. We are collaborating together on these initiatives. Every last woman, I'm asking you to let God speak to you to sow a seed of $20 to this vision house and the vision of taking those people up under the bridge and taking those people. Look, I want to talk to the kind of women, and I want you on my team, and I want to be on your team, and I'm already in Chris's team. I want women that immediately, when they heard that, they ready to leap. Like, where's the Cash App? What website we go to? That's in my line. $20. Well, you know what? If $20 causes you to stumble, you're not ready for vision. It's because what you make happen, this is another principle of vision, and I want my staff to get involved too. I'm going to be the first. What you make happen for others, God will make happen for you. So now, this is what I want you to do for everybody that's going to plant that 20. I didn't say 200. We could have easily said 200 because you are, there are some of you that can do 200, but I'm not an auctioneer. I don't do that kind of stuff. I just said, make it so people, there's no way they can't say, I can't do this. We're not going to leave you with an empty cupboard with no food and no sheets and no blankets and no coats and no bras. And we're not leaving those kids. I wish I could show you where they're coming out of. We have $20 faith, and nobody, and there may be somebody that God speaks to them for $1,000 or $200. That's between you and God. But every woman that says, I know I can sow $200. So people have, the women up under the bridge said, we just want a bra. We just want a coat. We just want a blanket. Some people just want food. Those kids, they just want a way out. We want to bring them for the weekend so they can have an opportunity to live a life that they've never lived before. And let's show God that we are not only able, but we're willing. And let's give the devil a black eye and manifest vision. If you're willing to do that with me, just raise your hand and say 20. I'm not afraid to sow 20. Come on. How many? I know that we're going to get at least 150 people that can say, I'm not afraid of $200. I mean, $20. That $200 keep coming up, but that's up to that person. I'm just keeping it very approachable and simple. Very approachable and simple. Thank you, Father. Now, this is as far as I can go. The rest is left to you, Daddy, to speak to people. All I can do is make the appeal. You speak to the people. You speak to the people. Right now on the screen, put on, you'll see the MTM Vision 2021 Cash App. And you wait till you see Minister Scott show you pictures. You wait till I show you the pictures. Ladies, don't you let the enemy rob you. Some of you that don't like to do Cash App are not able to do Cash App. Go to the website. Here's the website, patriciabailey.org. Put it on the screen, patriciabailey.org, and hit the donate button. And you wait till Minister Scott tells you what we did tonight, the vision that we manifest tonight. This is what got me. The reason, one of the reasons that motivated me about the house, Minister Scott, I said, how is Oprah Winfrey, Angelina Jolie, and Madonna the only kind of people that you see go pay cash for a house and bring kids from poor villages and scholarship them? Thank God for them. I honor them. And I thank God for what they're doing. But guess what? They're not the only ones that can do that. When we come together, ladies, we can do the same thing. We scholarship kids to school during this pandemic. We scholarship 14 kids to college in Haiti. Ladies, we have the vision to do this. What you make happen for others, God will make happen for you. And here's all the different ways that you can give. And you wait till you hear Minister Scott tally up everything, her and Val, and see what God is allowing us to do together. Every lady, I want you to want to give. I don't want you to feel pressured to give. I want you to want to give. I want you to want to be a part of the vision that Minister Scott and I are doing together. And the same way that video was put together, I want you to see the video of the coats and the bras and the food and all the things where the pantry gets filled again and the people get ministered to and the babies when they come into the vision house and when they're staying in their beds. I want you to be able to say, man, I was a part of that vision. and I'm giving God all the glory. Ladies, can you get excited? If you're excited about doing this, if you're excited about helping someone, if you're excited, some of you have been giving through the whole holiday season, I'm asking you to stretch a little bit more. And again, every woman, just put it in the chat if you're giving. Say, you can count on me, Minister Scott. And again, God may speak more to some other women. That's just where, that's the base. Let's just say that's the base of believing. And ladies, I want you to remember these principles of vision. You see through your eyes, not with your eyes. You see with vision. You got to elevate yourself to a higher place. Leave where you are. You got to keep that vision board and speak to that vision board. And you talk to it and you look at it at night before you go to bed, because it polarizes in your mind. And it's the first thing you look up at the top of the day. And it becomes so real to you that it's impossible for your human inner spirit not to believe that it's not a reality. And then as you keep speaking to it and feeding it with the word of God, visualization, as you keep looking at it, it's going to provide manifestation. And the biggest manifestation I'm excited about, I believe every last 150 women are going to give. And I can't wait to see the pictures, the footage, the videos of what you made happen, because we came together and cast a vision to help others. Ladies, mwah! Thank you. And I'm so scared I went over my time, but I was so excited and did all of this just for you, Minister Scott. That's my, I love it in you, baby. All this was just for you. So help me thank Ashton and Yolanda and my backup team, my back team, back office team, Val, Brandy, Terry, all those guys making it happen, wanting it to be first class just for you. Ladies, I want you to also to go follow me on YouTube. Oh, we made a 5,000, guys, but can we do 5,150 tonight by simply drop that in the chat going, that costs no money. Just go to YouTube and push subscribe and notification button. And there's a 3-minute video. I want them to put that 3-minute video up at the top. Somebody's going to have to move fast, Ashton, that they could take that 3-minute video that's on Facebook, the video on trusting God. Make that the first video on YouTube right quick, so they watch that little 3-minute video, because what YouTube makes us do now, they make everybody watch a 3-minute video before your subscription counts. So help us. And through doing that, you're allowing us to reach more people. Thank you so much. The giving is there. You can go to the website. You can go to the, it's in the chat, the Cash App, ladies. And ladies, let's show the atmosphere. Let's show the principalities. Let's show Almighty God. Let's show our sons and daughters. Let's show the community of us coming together vision. Let's show that we can do this. It's not just Mormons that can do this. And it's not just Muslims that can do this. And it's not just people of other different type of special interest groups that can do this. We can do this. We can do this. This is nothing for us. This is bread for us. And guess what, Minister Scott? This is just the beginning. When we come back together next time, it's going to be 300 women. And guess what? We're going to pay off people's loans and pay off things and take young girls in villages that have never had a chance to go to school, and young girls that have been child brides, and those that have been rape victims, and prevent misfortune in their life through the power of the vision that God has given us. I'm so excited about you creating a new vision for 2021 as you enter this new year with vision. Thank you. God bless you. And I can't wait to share the testimony with you. And y'all, make sure you tell Minister Scott to let me come back again. Y'all blow her up. Say, you need to get Dr. Bailey back again. Don't tell her I said it though. Don't tell her. But y'all blow her up and say, we need her back again. And we need to know what's the next level. We didn't come together just for this. What's the next thing we need to do together? Thank you. God bless you. Until next time, let's go make history together and let's go change nations together. God bless you.
Love you, Dr. Bailey. Thank you so much. Before you go, I got a little surprise for you as well. Thank you so much. We had one of the speakers, the ladies were like blowing up my phone and inboxing and stuff. And one of the speakers said, I'm giving $500. And she sold $500.
Stop it.
So we thank God for you. And Just may the wind, God, open the windows of heaven and pour blessings out in your life. We thank you because the storehouse is going to be restored. All the amazing things that we do, we can't wait to go with Dr. Bailey to the Vision House. That's my house. This is our house, Doc.
I told you that you and AC need to come on over. Let those women know, guess what? You're invited to the Vision House. There's going to be 40 beds in there. There's a bed for you. And we need you. Stop thinking that your money is to be made in America only. Stop thinking that you're supposed to go just travel in America only. Stretch your boundaries and your borders and just believe that the whole earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. And there's a whole world out there that's just waiting for you. So, and I want us to stay connected and do things together because I believe the best is yet to come in 2021. Ladies, thank you. Somebody else can let, you know what I like doing? I really like motivational giving. I mean, so there may be, this is just for those women who are risk takers like me. Anybody that wants to match me with $100, just no pressure, no pressure whatsoever. I'm talking about the want to ladies. Can I get 10 want to ladies that, you know what, Doc, $100 ain't gonna bankrupt me. I'll throw it on a card. Here it is. Can I find 10? We don't want the cupboard just filled. We want it overflowing. We want kids coming into that Vision House till we have opulence for them. I'm one. Can I get 9 other women that will join with me? This, now, if you don't want to, that I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to the ones, to the want to ladies. Where are my want to ladies? I'm not afraid to step out for 100. Wherever you are, some of them may be my staff. Anybody that wants to.
Put it in chat, ladies.
Put it in chat.
Want to lady.
Yep. And then you get back with me and let me know who our want to ladies are. That I just want to bless them with more. Because that's, just live to do it. I just love it. I love it. Let me do this as I hop off. And this is just, I was taught this by Apostle Frederick Casey Price. We call it motivational giving. And the Bible says that we provoke one another to good works. If you are a want to lady, now I see you. Just raise your hand if you want to join me with 100. Just if you want, look at that. 1, 2. See, I love to make the devil mad. 1, 2, 3. Help me out. I can't see. I don't have my glasses. Help a sister out. I think I saw 4. Raise your hand again. 1, 2, 3. I saw some other want to ladies, did I? Wave your hand if you're a want to lady. We're right at 5, I think. Did I see another want to lady? And then there are those that are like this. They like to give anonymous. You can give anonymous. I love you and I appreciate those anonymous people because those anonymous people just blow you away. Drop it in the chat if you want to give anonymous and say, I'm a want to lady. Thank you. Thank you, Denise Armstrong. Thank you, Cheryl Haynes. Thank you, Teresa Washington. Thank you, Arthur Bernetta Nelson. Thank you, Sandra Strong. Thank you, Denise Arnold. Thank you for Sandra. I know Sandra Vincent. Thank you, Kenyatta. Thank you, Christine Renata. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Samantha. Thank you. And Valerie and all the ladies. Thank you, Tawana Ware. Oh, Cassandra Wallace. Thank you so much. Pearl Washington, Judy Rogers. Thank you. Don James. Thank you. LaTanya Hudson. Man, a host of ladies. Josie, is that my Josie Martin? I thought that face looked familiar. Is that my Josie? Josie, let's connect. Christine Harris, thank you. God bless you. Bye-bye, ladies.
Doc, you just got to see this video real quick. It's a surprise for you. You probably haven't seen it in a while. I don't know where you were. But Christine, please go ahead and play that surprise video. You ladies, sing along with Doc.
Okay.
Here we go. We
got to
do one more chorus.
Sing the word. How did you find
it? Cause every little thing is gonna be all right.
We're in the combo.
About a thing. Cause every little thing is gonna be all right.
That's awesome.
That's
on the show.
Don't worry.
I hear the ladies
up here.
But
sing, ladies.
Don't worry, sweet thing. Don't worry.
And they sing that right before they get on the boat with no life raft.
Risk takers. That was in the Congo, Chris. That was in a war zone in the Congo. They are rescuing babies that were rape victims. This is who we are, and this is what we do. And we made it home alive. Thank you. We love you. God bless you. I love you, ladies. I love you. And thank you for trusting me. Ladies, thank you so much.
Appreciate
and
you.
I think I forgot to thank all the ladies for giving. Thank you for giving so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you for your sacrifice. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Doc. We love you.
Thank you more.
Ladies, we're winding up, but again, on behalf of Doc and myself, thank you so much for giving to the ministry, MTM, and giving to us that continue to go out there and feed the homeless. And we promise them that we will be back. And it's so true what Doc said. The storehouse has been empty. So Chaplain AC and I are trying to replenish to take some more stuff out to the homeless. So we thank you all for your giving. I want to say thank you before DJ Candy comes back on and takes us out on the ones and the twos. And let's thank a few people here. I want to say thank you to our sponsors, Vivian Crawley, Henton Jones Media, Bloom by Kenyatta, our very own Kenyatta, my doctor. Again, thank you to Samantha Samuels on Authentic Me Coaching. Thank you so much. Thank you, Judy Forbin, for sponsoring as well. Again, thank you to the amazing Dr. Bailey. I love to just sit at her feet and just hear some words of wisdom. We got off the phone with her earlier, my husband and I, and we looked at each other like, she is so wise. I mean, like, really, even on up-to-date things. So thank you, Lord, that I'm seeing with different eyes these days, and I love it. And thank you to my amazing sister and friend, Pastor Denise. Pastor Denise, you want to say a word? Where are you, sis? Make sure you go out and rent the movie Overcomer. It's truly amazing. Her role in there, she should have received an Academy Award or something. Where are you, Pastor Denise?
Hey guys, can you hear me?
Yes.
Hey, I really thank you so much. I hope you got some nuggets. She said, you know, the things that she said, and as you see, she told you to look up and to look out. And she said, you know, sow, sell your seeds, be plentiful. You know, there were so many nuggets, she said, you know, it's what you let in your life that you live by, you know? And she just said, you just don't associate with everything that's going around. And as you do those vision boards, we made a lot of different situations, but the one thing about a vision board is so amazing is you can always go back and tweak it. can always go back and see it, because here she showed you just giving of $20, that her vision, when she put it before God, God blessed it and people started giving. And that's the same thing with your visions, whether it's your, you know, your writing, your producing, your publishing, whatever your vision is, your ministry, your 501(c), whatever it is that these ladies have put into your life, it's available to you. No one stops you but you. And she said it was a planned pandemic. And I agree with her. I've been saying that forever, but we're not a part of the plan. We're not a part of that plan. And you know, Pastor Chris was on earlier today and she was going to the store trying to buy things for people who had a request. Guys, you got stuff in that closet that you're not going to get back in. That's just an honesty. If you've been a four and you're like a 12, you're not going to be a four again. You may not even want to be a four again. I wouldn't want to be a four or a six again. You know, pack those things up, get with Chris and, you know, be a blessing to somebody else. Be a blessing to somebody else. And, you know, plant your seed overseas. That's what I liked. You know, we do a lot here. So now you got opportunity to plant with Pastor Chris here, but she is in partnership with her. So every time you sow a seed to her here, it's still going abroad because they're in partnership. So I just, it's been a wonderful, thank you, ladies. Thank you so much for the connection. Thank you, honored to be a part of it. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And this looks like it's going to be your permanent thing every year. I want to say thank you to Samantha Samuels, one of our awesome speakers. And she spoke on, what did she speak on? Does anybody know? Time management. And something that I always say in my coaching classes, time is your most valuable currency. And once spent, you can never get it back. Never get it back. Thank you, Kim. I see you. I'll connect with you so you can help me give those items out in Atlanta as well. And want to say thank you to Coach Brunetta Nelson, graduate of my course, just doing some amazing things. Thank you to Speaker Vanessa Johnson. The fight is fixed. Your fight is fixed, so you cannot lose, y'all. And thank you, Judy Forbin, on speaking on the nonprofit formation and all these awesome things. Thank you, Coach Kenyatta Collins. Amazing job talking about our health in 2020. Yes, I take your advice because I know you'll text me and say you need to come see me. So thank you for that. And thank you, Dawn James, all the way in Costa Rica. We're going to be visiting her sometime next year. All you ladies that want to do missions with us, we're excited about that. We're going to do a missions training in Costa Rica. Want to say thank you to DJ Candy. DJ Candy, you are truly amazing, woman of God, and I truly appreciate you. And want to say thank you to Christine. Let's put our hands together, big hands together for Christine, who was able to put this platform together and just allow us to be on here. She's that technical girl. I love her. That woman that you know, that will run circles around technical men. I just love her dearly. And thank you, Christine. We appreciate you. You did an outstanding job. And Ashton from South Africa, thank you for connecting with Christine and you guys making it happen. Thank you for all the people from South Africa. We so appreciate you, all the people from Kenya, Zimbabwe, all of the amazing places. Those of you in Trinidad and Tobago, thank you for joining. Jamaica, I think the people from the Pregnancy Resource House in Jamaica joined us as well. And the young girls were there, the young mothers doing their vision board as well. So many people have been touched and we thank God for that. Definitely.
I'll say one more thing.
Yes.
I just wanted to thank all our Can We Talk family.
Yes, please.
And supported. I want to thank all of you guys, all our prayer warriors, all our 7 o'clock people that came on and just joined the vision. We, you know, Can We Talk provides truth, encouragement, enlightenment, and education for your consideration. And I want to do a big shout out to Dwight, who is the founder of Music is the Answer and Rocker's Revenge. He sent it out all over to his men to get their
women. Wow.
So I appreciate the heart of everybody, Dr. Pamela Smith and Judy and everybody else and Michelle and the whole group that supported Pastor Scott, like we support each other. Pastor Scott in New York supports Pastor Scott here. So I just wanted to thank our Can We Talk family. We appreciate you so much for your support.
And I appreciate Can We Talk. I appreciate the word that I get from you, Pastor Denise, every morning at 7 a.m. I might be still in my bed, but every Sunday morning at 7 a.m., but I listen and I communicate. Thank you so much for all that you do. You're a blessing in my life, and I know you're a blessing in a lot of people's lives, and you're an agent of change in the industry of film and theater, and I thank you for that, and I thank you for your team. Thank you so much. Thank you to MTM Masters Touch Ministries, Dr. Patricia Bailey. Remember, ladies, there's so many opportunities on here to do some great things. I think from what I see, it looks like the January class may be filled, but I'll open that up for you for February. So make sure you go on to globalconnectionsacademy.org. globalconnectionsacademy.org and become a certified life coach. Your life will be changed forever. We have some mentorship opportunities. If you're looking for a mentor, I can definitely connect you with one of our life coaches. So put that information in chat and write that vision. And those of you, when you're done with your board,
You're on mute. We can't hear you.
We can't hear you, Chris.
Minister, we can't hear you.
Can't hear you.